Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, committee members. Yesterday, we made excellent use of our time together. We have now caught up with the items foreseen in the provisional timetable and advanced slightly. We have finished all of the files for the representative list under item 8B, as well as the items 8C and 8D on the Register of Good Safeguarding Practices and International Assistance, respectively. Finally, we returned to item 8 on the report of the evaluation body and started the debate. The Bureau met this morning for the fourth time. During the meeting, we agreed to adjust the provisional timetable to reflect the advancement of item 8. There's a chance that we will be able to finish all items today if we all work hard and efficiently. Distinguished delegates, without further delay, let us now continue our meeting by returning item 8 on the overall report of the evaluation body. When we ended our session yesterday, we had the following committee members on our speakers list: Netherlands, Switzerland, Kuwait, Sri Lanka, Cote d'Ivoire, and Peru. We also had the following states' parties who are not members of the committee: Austria, Latvia, and Armenia. Netherlands, you have the floor.
Thank you, Madam Chair. The Netherlands would like to congratulate all the states' parties and the communities with the new inscriptions, and we would like to thank the evaluation body again for their report and detailed recommendations. As we said in our statement earlier, we value the expertise of the evaluation body, and we believe we have to respect these recommendations. Due to the special circumstances of this meeting and the lack of time, we feel that the committee could not discuss properly the recommendations to the files. Like the delegation from Czechia said yesterday, the original draft decisions contain many serious issues, concerns, and challenges directly related to the principles of the convention. For instance, on the involvement of communities. Sometimes the recommendations were removed or were redrafted in such a way that not much was left of the original concerns or issues. And we believe these concerns as presented in the decisions are important all the more because all the minor questions have already been settled by the upstream dialogue mechanism. These recommendations represent valuable guidance for implementing the safeguarding measures and the monitoring of the elements. We would like to ask the evaluation body to reflect on this in relation to the concerns expressed by the evaluation body about a lack of quality of the files. For instance, regarding the definition of the element and its social functions and cultural significance and the role of communities. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Netherlands. I now give the floor to Switzerland.
Je vous remercie, Madame la Présidente. La Suisse félicite les États parties et les communautés qui ont vu leurs éléments inscrits. Nous encourageons les États soumissionnaires à tenir compte des importantes remarques de l'organe d'évaluation dans la préparation de leur future candidature. En ce sens, nous regrettons que les recommandations et observations de l'organe d'évaluation n'aient pas été systématiquement maintenues dans les projets de décision par le comité. Nous souhaitons aborder deux points qui ressortent de ce cycle. Premièrement, nous saluons le nombre croissant de candidatures multinationales. Certaines difficultés en matière de collaboration et de participation des communautés ont néanmoins été observées. Pour y remédier et aider les États soumissionnaires, il nous paraît nécessaire de mettre en place des lignes directrices basées sur les recommandations de l'organe d'évaluation. D'où cette question adressée à Madame la rapporteuse de l'organe d'évaluation, comment de telles recommandations pourraient-elles être formulées? La Suisse et la Côte d'Ivoire proposeront, avec le soutien du Koweït, un amendement au paragraphe 8 du projet de décision destiné à améliorer la qualité des candidatures multinationales. Deuxièmement, nous nous réjouissons de l'augmentation du nombre d'éléments favorisant la durabilité environnementale. Cette question liée à l'agenda 2030 est particulièrement importante pour notre convention et nous félicitons le secrétariat pour le remarquable travail effectué dans ce contexte avec le projet Dive into ICH. De même, nous rappelons la décision de la semaine passée du Conseil exécutif de l'UNESCO concernant les impacts du changement climatique sur tous les patrimoines. Il nous semble important de refléter ces enjeux de manière plus systématique dans les candidatures elles-mêmes. C'est pourquoi la Suisse a déposé un amendement invitant le secrétariat à proposer une réflexion pour mieux intégrer la question de la durabilité. Je vous remercie de votre attention.
Thank you, Switzerland. Kuwait, you may take the floor.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Kuwait also would like to first congratulate the state parties and the communities for the new inscription. And also would like to thank the evaluation body for the job and the great job they've done. Also, Kuwait would like to echo what Netherlands says. And I think, you know, some of the files has some concerns, even though we, so the committee changed the decision, but those concerns, it would be, I think it was be good if some of them kept on the draft decision, the decisions, so the state parties keep it in mind. Also, Kuwait would like to urge the evaluation body to utilize the use of technology in the process. I think we have this exceptional year. And like we saw from the secretariats, you know, in the past 6 months, there is a huge improvement in the efficiency of the meetings and get things done much quicker time, even with the online consultation or on the online meeting. So I think, you know, I urge the evaluation body for the future work to utilize the technology to have their job easier, more efficient and time-saving and cost-effective. Thank you, Madam Chair.
Thank you, Kuwait. Sri Lanka, you may take the floor.
Thank you, Madam Chair. The Sri Lankan delegation wishes to extend our gratitude to all the members of the evaluation body for their hard work to make the 15th session a success despite the challenges we had to face due to the COVID-19 pandemic. Thank you, and we would also like to state that despite the fact that the Intergovernmental Committee may have overridden certain remarks made by the evaluation body, it is paramount that the state parties should address these concerns which were made by the evaluation body in order to preserve the living heritage of their communities. Thank you.
Thank you, Sri Lanka. Cote d'Ivoire, the floor is yours. Cote d'Ivoire, you may take the floor.
Merci, Madame la Présidente. La Côte d'Ivoire tient d'abord à exprimer sa satisfaction quant à la façon équilibrée avec laquelle vous dirigez cette session jusqu'à présent. Elle félicite une fois de plus l'organe d'évaluation pour son travail d'analyse minutieuse des différents dossiers, ce qui a permis non seulement de mettre en lumière les points importants de chaque dossier, mais aussi de pouvoir tenir dans ce timing que nous impose le coronavirus cette année. Alors, il est vrai que l'examen des différentes candidatures a permis d'inscrire de nouveaux éléments sur la sauvegarde du PCI, mais cet examen également a montré des limites qui amènent la Côte d'Ivoire à encourager le secrétariat à faire deux choses. Premièrement, poursuivre le dialogue en amont avec les États soumissionnaires de candidature. Cela nous semble important pour réduire les difficultés de renseignement des formulaires. Deuxièmement, initier en faveur des États parties des programmes de renforcement de capacités, prenant notamment en compte leurs besoins, dont certains ont transparu dans les différents dossiers que l'organe d'évaluation a analysés. Et nous tenons par exemple, à citer pour exemple qu'aucun État parti, en tout cas cela nous engage, aucun État parti ne peut avoir des difficultés à savoir que tel ou tel élément de sa communauté est un PCI. Mais de là à renseigner cela dans le document de candidature pour satisfaire la R1, nous convenons que ce n'est pas facile pour tous les États partis de faire ainsi. Et en retour, la Côte d'Ivoire encourage aussi les États partis soumissionnaires à solliciter auprès du secrétariat une assistance technique dans la rédaction même du dossier de candidature, et si cela est admis, bien sûr. Et si cela est fait, les États partis vont finalement maîtriser progressivement les mécanismes de la convention. Je vous remercie, Madame la Présidente.
Thank you, Côte d'Ivoire. Peru, you may take the floor.
Muchas gracias, muy buenos días. Buen día, señora presidenta. Buen día a todos los miembros del, de este comité, de este distinguido comité, y a los observadores. El Perú desea tomar la palabra para agradecer al órgano de evaluación por su excelente trabajo y por sus acuciosas recomendaciones en relación al trabajo en futuro en, sobre nuestras listas en la convención. Deseamos invocar, perdón, a los estados parte a utilizar con mayor énfasis el mecanismo de la lista de salvaguardia urgente. Vemos todavía un gran desequilibrio entre el uso de la lista representativa, muy interesante y también un buen mecanismo de salvaguardia, pero consideramos que hay que poner cierto énfasis en la lista de salvaguardia urgente, porque sabemos que más aún ahora, después de esta pandemia, habrá todavía más elementos por diversos factores como la migración, la acentuación de la pobreza, etcétera, habrá aún más elementos probablemente en riesgo de desaparición. Por lo tanto, invitamos al comité a reflexionar en una futura reunión sobre cómo continuar mejorando el interés o incentivando el interés en la lista de salvaguardia urgente. Y finalmente, felicitar nuevamente a la presidenta por su excelente conducción de nuestros debates. Muchísimas gracias.
Thank you, Peru. I would like to ask the Secretariat at this point to read out the remaining list of speakers. Mr. Curtis.
Thank you, Madam Chair. The list I have now, firstly, for committee members. Brazil, Saudi Arabia, Kazakhstan, China, Morocco, Japan, and then for non-committee members, Armenia, Austria, Latvia, Palestine. Thank you, Madam Chair.
Thank you, Mr. Curtis. Brazil, you may take the floor. Thank you.
Gracias, señora presidenta. Buenos días a todos. Quisiéramos felicitar a los Estados miembros y a las comunidades cuyas candidaturas fueron inscritas en la lista de la Convención y muy especialmente a los países iberoamericanos por la vecindad histórica que nos une. Nos alegra, señora presidenta, ver que el proceso de diálogo está definitivamente incorporado al trabajo del órgano evaluador, cuya excelencia una vez más se ha demostrado. Y el proceso de diálogo hemos visto ha funcionado muy bien, porque inclusive en este evento virtual hemos podido superar algunas dificultades que candidaturas que no habían usufruido la posibilidad de este diálogo pudieron presentar sus consideraciones y las candidaturas fueron definitivamente incorporadas. Aprovecho, señora presidenta, para felicitar a usted por la forma como está conduciendo esta reunión y a la Secretaría por el trabajo hecho. Muchas gracias. Felicitaciones a todos. Gracias.
Thank you, Brazil. Saudi Arabia, you may take the floor. Thank you.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Saudi Arabia would also like to congratulate all the state parties for their new inscriptions of elements. We understand the fact that due to the restrictions of virtual meetings, active support methodology has been implemented to propose amendments. However, we would like to echo other committee members in the fact that it was difficult sometimes to reflect and react upon some decisions due to the limited time. We understand the fact that this is the first time we're having meetings online. However, it is an opportunity for us to reflect and improve on in any coming sessions in case we have the same circumstances. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Saudi Arabia. Kazakhstan, please take the floor. Thank you.
Thank you, Madam Chairperson. Let me express our congratulations to your balanced chairing and secretariat for its marvelous work under very hard circumstances. We join to congratulations to the state parties with new inscriptions, which for sure will add more bright colors to convention. Kazakhstan is very grateful to the committee members for support of the nomination of our country in cooperation with Turkey and Kyrgyzstan. My delegation wants to thank the evaluation body and say a special shukra to its chairman, Mr. Albusaid. We took comprehensive notes on the evaluation body and comments, and it would be adequately reflected in all future plans of safeguarding and strengthening the element. We would like also to reiterate the comments raised by some of committee members during the session about the need for precise clarification of the criteria R2 and R3. Maybe at some point, the committee may wish propose to establish a working group on this important issue. Thank you, Madam Chair. Big up, Jamaica.
Thank you. Thank you, Kazakhstan. China, the floor is yours.
Delegation would like to congratulate all the states parties for their new inscriptions and selections as best practices. We would like to commend again all the evaluation body members for their excellent work and the assistance of the Secretariat under the difficult circumstances arising from the COVID-19 pandemic. And we also appreciate all the recommendations by the evaluation body based on its evaluation work. And we hope all the state parties would take full advantage of all the good examples for more quality nominations in the future cycles. And we also noticed that the evaluation body observed many recurring issues, such as over-commercialization, folklorization, decontextualization, musifications, and et cetera. And we hope that we could count on the Secretariat to develop more guidance documents to help with all the states parties for their elaborations of nomination files and planning and implementation for the safeguarding measures in the future. Thank you, Madam Chair.
Thank you, China. Morocco, the floor is yours.
Merci, Madame la Présidente. Je tiens tout d'abord à vous saluer pour la direction efficace de nos travaux et de nos débats. Je veux également féliciter tous les États parties et les communautés locales qui ont vu leurs éléments inscrits sur les différentes listes de notre comité. Nous saluons également l'excellent travail de l'organe d'évaluation ainsi que le travail du secrétariat dans les conditions difficiles que nous vivons actuellement. Nous pensons que les candidatures renvoyées aux États commissionnaires ne signifie pas un rejet définitif et que c'est un appel à une amélioration du dossier. Et d'ailleurs, nombre de pastoraux missionnaires ont pu rattraper les quelques problèmes soulevés par l'organe d'évaluation et faire donc inscrire leurs éléments. Nous nous félicitons également de l'aboutissement positif du dossier multinational du couscous qui a été inscrit sur la liste représentative du patrimoine culturel et matériel de l'humanité. Et à cet égard, nous remercions l'ensemble des membres du comité qui ont donc confirmé cette inscription. Merci, Madame la Présidente.
Thank you, Morocco. Japan, the floor is yours.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Madam Chair. First of all, I would like to echo the voices of other delegations in expressing our sincere appreciation for your leadership in the meeting. The meeting has been quite successful, and thank you very much for that. And secondly, I would also like to congratulate all the state parties, including us, in fact, for new inscription. And thirdly, I would like to express our appreciation to the evaluation body for very high quality analysis of individual items. And in this regard, I would also like to note with great satisfaction the success of the upstream dialogue. Our understanding is that 10 out of 11 cases have been guided towards successful inscription, and that was a very important achievement. In one case, there was a bit of a difference on that, but on the particular file, we were able to hear clarifications from Malaysia and Indonesia, which were, I believe, were quite convincing in many ways. So that was, I think that was a good development. In any case, it is good to note that the value of this upstream dialogue has been demonstrated in this current cycle. Finally, I understand that Switzerland is going to propose two amendments to the decisions. Perhaps we have to wait to see those amendments on the screen. But let me just make one very brief remarks about those two points that Switzerland raised. One is about the sustainability, the element of sustainability in the context of inscription. We fully support what Switzerland believes. And secondly, on the question of multilateral files, maybe we need some more clarification on this. So I'll come back to that point later when we discuss amendment. Thank you. Thank you, Madam Chair.
Thank you, Japan. Thank you. Panama, you may take the floor. Thank you.
Hello, good morning. Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you. Please go ahead. Good morning. Thank you.
Good morning, Madam Chair. For us, it's a great pleasure today to want to congratulate the evaluation group and also the secretariat for the excellent work of this meeting. And of course, you, Madam Chairman, for the way the whole meeting has gone through and in a very speedy way. We would like to make reference to point 77 of the report in what is called recurring challenges. We feel that this is at the core of the future meetings and the future work of the Secretariat as a supporting body to the member states. These are challenges, no doubt, but these are very important challenges in terms of the future capacity building that our countries need, that our community needs, and especially the ministries in charge of foreseeing how this application of our convention will go forward. These are very, very important activities that I hope the Secretariat would be able to suggest how we can build capacity building plans and programs for the next years and following times. Because when you talk about issues like confusion between inscriptions, concerns linked to top-down absence of measures, importance of audiovisual materials, confusion again. It means that we probably need to do more information services. We need to do really capacity building with the communities. And I would suggest that it should be inserted in the final report of this committee. Thank you again to you, Madam Chair, and to the Secretariat for the excellent work. Carry forward with our convention. Thank you.
Thank you, Panama. At this time, I will ask Armenia to take the floor. Please respect the 2 minutes time limit that is offered to each speaker. Thank you. Go ahead, Armenia. Thank you.
Thank you, Madam Chairperson, for giving us the floor. The delegation of Armenia would like to refer to the nomination Art of Miniature presented by Azerbaijan, Islamic Republic of Iran, Turkey, and Uzbekistan. In this regard, and without any prejudice to the nomination as a whole, we would like to reiterate the preoccupations contained in our concern letter uploaded on the committee website with regard to the claims of Azerbaijan concerning the presence of Azerbaijani miniature art school inside Nagorno-Karabakh. Due to the lack of time, we will refrain from presenting in details the argumentation contained in the letter. However, we would like to state once again that the type of miniature the nomination referred to has never existed on the territory of Nagorno-Karabakh. The miniature of Nagorno-Karabakh has fundamental thematic differences, which was confirmed by relevant experts. The absence of letters of consent from the representatives of the region is another proof of the above said. Finally, we believe that the requirement of scientific rigor must, in all circumstances, take precedence over any other consideration. Nevertheless, we note with regret that Azerbaijan continues to use the nomination process for political purposes through systematic insertion of reference to Karabakh in almost all its nominations. Madam Chairperson, we would request to include this statement in the summary records of the meeting. And by concluding, we would like to congratulate you, Madam Chairperson, for the excellent conduct of our meeting and also to congratulate all countries for their successful nominations. I do thank you for your attention.
Thank you, Armenia. I will now recognize Austria. You may take the floor. Thank you.
Yeah, Madam Chair, please first let me congratulate you on your chairmanship, and our sincere congratulations go to all countries and elements of ICH that have been inscribed in the lists and registered during this week. Further, the Austrian delegation would also like to commend the Secretariat for all its work under these extraordinary circumstances for the excellent preparation of the meeting and of the documents. Our delegation congratulates the evaluation body for the coherence and diligence of its work, the detailed and insightful report, and its extraordinary efforts and dedication to the evaluation of nominations. We highly appreciate your work. There is one recurrent issue that we are still seriously concerned about. Having followed the work of the committee over the last days and having seen that a number of nominations submitted in this cycle have been inscribed regardless of the recommendations given by the evaluation body, which is in fact a group of experts and accredited NGOs established by the committee itself. Some very relevant comments were neglected or deleted. The decisions taken seem to imply that a new tacit rule has been established, which says that elements are inscribed if 3 out of 5 criteria are satisfied, even if the evaluation body pointed out serious issues under 1 or 2 criteria. We are concerned that the current practice will have a distinctive impact on the future of the lists. Madam Chair, for our delegation, the credibility of the current inscription mechanism, including the dialogue process, is at stake. We trust that the global reflection process on the role and functions of the list will lead the way towards a satisfying solution one that will increase awareness about good safeguarding practices and further enhance dialogue and cooperation among communities and countries. Thank you, Madam Chair.
Thank you, Austria. I now invite Latvia to take the floor.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Let me present a joint statement of the delegations of Latvia and Estonia. Our cooperation proactively responds to the online meeting constraints in the spirit of the convention while economizing screen time. We highly appreciate your efficient leadership of this novel convention format. We commend the commitment of the evaluation body and committee for fulfilling responsibilities in online modalities. And we appreciate the efficacy of the Secretariat in adapting to the current pandemic circumstance. We regret that the urgent safeguarding list and the register of good safeguarding practices continue to attract limited attention. However, we wish to highlight the positive increase in multinational proposals, revealing the diversity of our shared heritage. Being aware of the challenges of applying present evaluation priorities while keeping a limited number of files per cycle, we hope to see multinational files being evaluated also in future cycles. Latvian and Estonian delegations would like to echo the emphasis on the monitoring of inscribed elements as expressed in the report of the evaluation body, as well as in the report of the ICH NGO forum discussed earlier this week. We acknowledge the need for more inclusive and participatory reporting where various partners could contribute, including UNESCO chairs active in the field of ICH, for instance. Finally, we congratulate communities, groups, and individuals and states with new inscriptions this year. We look forward to their follow-up and welcome the quick return of the files referred on committee's agenda. Thank you, Madam Chair.
Thank you, Latvia. I now invite Palestine to take the floor.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Let me first congratulate all state parties who inscribed an element on the representative list. And let me warmly thank the evaluation body for their hard work despite the difficult circumstances. Madam Chair, we notice that the session went very smoothly, and especially when it came to inscription. And this is due, of course, to your chairmanship, but also to the upstream process and also to the respect of the gentleman agreement and as well the decision making by steps. And I'm glad for this respect, since the idea came from me since 4 years ago. The gentleman agreement is not to refrain from opening the debate on elements who are not to inscribe. It is not to change the recommendation of the evaluation body from refer or not to inscribe to inscribe when it comes to an element that does not satisfy more than two criteria. And this has been respected. And I hope that in the future, this becomes a regular practice of the committee. The second thing, we are looking forward to see the outcome of the working group on the revision of the criteria and the different mechanisms. After that, I think that we need to reconsider again the insertion of another degree in the evaluation between referral and not to inscribe, something like deferral. The proposal has been raised in the past, but I think with the situation that we met with the Democratic Republic of Korea, I think it is absolutely justified. And to conclude, Madam Chair, let me congratulate all the actors for the success of this session, starting by the Secretary, by you and all members of the committee, and of course, the evaluation body. Thank you very much. Merci beaucoup, Madame la Présidente.
Thank you, Ambassador. Thank you. I will now give the floor to Azerbaijan. But I would like to indicate at this time, again, to remind that we have 2 minutes for each presentation. Azerbaijan, please go ahead.
Merci, Madame la Présidente. Il est regrettable que le comité soit une fois de plus confronté à une autre situation où l'Arménie tente de s'immiscer dans les affaires intérieures de l'Azerbaïdjan et d'autres États soumissionnaires qui unissent leurs efforts pour préparer une candidature multinationale. En ce qui concerne la mention du Karabakh dans le dossier, l'Azerbaïdjan souhaite rappeler que les communautés et les praticiens des écoles des miniatures de Bakou, de Karabakh, de Chamakhi et de Ganja constituent quatre piliers importants de l'art de la miniature en Azerbaïdjan.
Allô.
L'art de miniature au Karabakh s'est développé au XIIIe siècle et a joué depuis lors un rôle important dans le développement des expressions artistiques traditionnelles, des peintures murales et de l'artisanat au Karabakh et dans d'autres régions de l'Azerbaïdjan. L'existence de l'école d'art miniature de Karabakh a été gravement affectée par l'occupation du Karabakh et de cette région adjacente par l'Arménie au début des années 90. L'art a continué à vivre et à être soutenu par des praticiens individuels en dehors du Karabakh, y compris les personnes déplacées qui avaient été expulsées de la région à la suite de l'occupation. L'école d'art de miniature de Karabakh reste une partie du patrimoine des communautés en Azerbaïdjan et personne n'a le droit de prendre aux communautés à ce qui leur appartient, leur créativité, leur culture qui transcende les religions et ethnies. Et nous espérons que les artistes pourront très bientôt visiter le Karabakh et la ville de Chusha récemment libérée. Nous exprimons enfin l'espoir que la prochaine fois que l'Arménie revendiquera des territoires de ses pays voisins et pourra des conflits en créant des divisions entre les peuples de la région. Les autorités arméniennes réfléchiront réellement à ce qu'ils peuvent faire pour soutenir le dialogue interculturel, la paix, la coexistence pacifique des communautés de culture dans la région. Je vous prie de bien vouloir inclure cette déclaration dans le rapport. Merci, Madame la Présidente.
Thank you, Azerbaijan. At this time, I will give the floor to the evaluation body to respond to the comments and questions from the states. Please go ahead, Chairman.
Madam Chairperson, distinguished delegates, ladies and gentlemen, the evaluation body thanks the committee for the confidence it has placed in it. The members would like to congratulate the state parties for the inclusions of the new elements in the mechanisms of the 2003 Convention. We would like to thank those countries whose files have been selected as good examples, as they have enlarged the list of inspirations showing the wide variability of living heritage, as well as of possible approaches to safeguarding the ICH. The members also appreciate the state parties' decision to take the recommendation to refer a file as an invitation and chance to further develop the nomination files and the possibility to enrich the presentation of an element with valuable additional information. This might be maybe an answer to the question of how to improve the nomination files in the future, and maybe also find inspiration in the original drafts as suggested by the evaluation body. The body would like to state that it could be compared to a loving parent who at times deprives his children of a small amount of joy, not for his own pleasure, but with a view of building a future happiness of these children. It is therefore, although with reluctance, that evaluation body sometimes decides to recommend a file for referral. However, these recommendations are always made in the sincere hope that in one of the following cycles, the presentation of the element and its safeguarding in the nomination file will come back improved. Concerning the necessity of the guidelines related to the multinational nominations, the EB welcomes the ongoing global reflection on the listing mechanisms of the convention, and that might help to solve the issue. Meanwhile, we would recommend to take into consideration the good examples of multinational nominations recommended by the EB and the committee. To echo some of the comments as expressed by the committee members, as in previous cycles, the members of the body noted an inequality in the nomination file submitted. The representative list was accorded by far the most importance by submitting states, while the other three mechanisms were underused. The body discussed the evolving character of the interpretation of the convention, which also needs to be reflected in the evaluation process. also thanks to the 2003 convention. Nowadays, the idea of the importance of ICH in our lives in general is much more widespread than it was 20 years ago. Therefore, the discussions evolved around the necessity to shift our attention towards a more effective and well-designed safeguarding of the ICH that is based on mutual cooperation of various stakeholders. We believe that the inscription should be not the goal of all our efforts, but the beginning of a beautiful and adventurous journey of building a collaborative spirit and actions around safeguarding the living heritage in our world of diversity. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you, Ms. Valansko. Members, we have completed our general debate regarding the report of the evaluation body. Please refer to document 8 and its draft decision in paragraph 7-8. I understand that Switzerland submitted two amendments, one on paragraph 8 and one on a new paragraph 9. If it is so, if it is the wish that Switzerland be given the floor to present these amendments when we reach their respective paragraphs, I would ask that they be put on the screen. I think that we can now proceed with the adoption of the decision as shown on the screens, paragraph by paragraph. Paragraph 1, citing the documents we have examined. I believe there is no objection here. Can we adopt? Adopted. Paragraph 2, recalling the operational directives and the resolution of the General Assembly that introduced the dialogue process. Do I see any objection? No objection. Adopted. Paragraph 3, expressing our satisfaction with the quality of the evaluation, the work of the evaluation body, and appreciating the support by the Secretariat. I trust that we can all agree here. Adopted. Paragraph 4, taking note of the unprecedented circumstances of the pandemic, and appreciating that the 2020 cycle files could be evaluated in a timely manner. I think it is indeed important to recognize the great efforts made by the evaluation body and the Secretariat in this regard. I see no objection. Adopted. Paragraph 5. Welcoming the positive results of the first full implementation of the dialogue process. Are there any objections? I see no objection. Adopted. Paragraph 6, congratulating submitting states whose nominations are considered as good examples. I do not see any objections. Adopted. Paragraph 7, related to the observations and recommendations made by the evaluation body concerning its work for the 2020 cycle. There are no objections. I see none. Adopted. Paragraph 8, appreciating the high increase of multinational nominations in this cycle and giving recommendations in that regard. I see there is an amendment tabled by Switzerland at the end of the paragraph. Would Switzerland like to present it?
Thank you. Merci, Madame la Présidente. Ensemble avec l'organe d'évaluation, nous avons l'impression qu'il y a une nécessité de favoriser, de faciliter, d'améliorer la qualité des candidatures multinationales qui sont tellement importantes. Notre proposition vise à mettre à disposition des outils et des conseils pour la préparation des dossiers multinationaux sur la base des recommandations de l'organe d'évaluation et de bonnes pratiques identifiées. Nous visons un processus léger qui pourrait être mis en place par le secrétariat en collaboration avec l'organe d'évaluation. Merci.
Thank you, Switzerland. Does any other committee member wish to take the floor? Japan, please take the floor.
Thank you, Madam Chair. We are not necessarily opposed to the notion of some kind of guidance for the multilateral files, but I'm not sure if it is a good idea for the Secretariat to prepare a guidance for, you know, state members. In that connection, I remember the rapporteur of the evaluation body also referred to this point. If I'm not mistaken, she did refer to this point, and she was suggesting that a global reflection process can probably take care of the discussions, possible discussions, and perhaps possible solutions on this issue. So one idea here would be to have a language saying that, invite the open-ended intergovernmental working group on the global reflection to discuss the preparation of multinational files. Something like that would probably be better in this context. Thank you, Madam Chair.
Thank you. Côte d'Ivoire, you may take the floor.
Merci, Madame la Présidente. La Côte d'Ivoire est très sensible aux candidatures multinationales parce qu'en Afrique, on a beaucoup de points communs avec plusieurs pays ensemble. Vous savez comment l'Afrique a été découpée avec les frontières, si bien qu'il y a beaucoup de similitudes d'une région à l'autre. Et c'est ainsi que nous pensons que les candidatures multinationales sont intéressantes en ce sens que les dossiers auront du poids et elles permettraient également au plan culturel de montrer l'unité qu'il y a d'un pays à l'autre. C'est pour ça que la Côte d'Ivoire soutient cet amendement et c'est pour ça également que la Côte d'Ivoire pense qu'il faut que nous allions vers nous favorisions les candidatures multinationales. Et pour nous, Africains, c'est important, ces candidatures multinationales. C'est pour ça qu'on a demandé que l'organe d'évaluation nous aide à, que le secrétariat nous aide à préparer des notes d'orientation précises pour favoriser ces candidatures multinationales. C'est vrai qu'il y a une réflexion globale qui est menée actuellement, mais nous sommes un peu réticents par rapport au temps que ça va mettre pour donner les résultats sur cette note d'orientation. C'est pour ça que nous proposons qu'une préparation soit faite spécialement pour ces candidatures multinationales. Je vous remercie, Madame la Présidente. Je vous félicite pour votre leadership. Merci, Madame.
Thank you, Côte d'Ivoire. I now recognize Brazil.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Can you listen to me? Because apparently I had a problem with the sound.
I'm hearing you loud and clear.
Oh, that's fantastic. Madam Chair, we will, of course, support the idea of stimulating multinational candidature. We think this is an important element to increase diversity and also to show how the connection between elements and countries happens, and I think is very important. I want to nonetheless support the proposal made by the distinguished delegate of Japan that we somehow include member states in the reflection on possible notes of orientation in this regard. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Brazil. Kuwait, please take the floor.
Thank you, Madam Chair. I just wanted to clarify, you know, the reasoning behind this draft amendment that's submitted by Switzerland and Kuwait, Côte d'Ivoire. We are not, and I understand what His Excellency, the Ambassador of Japan, is voting for the working group and the reflecting, you know, I think in that sense, what he meant that, you know, what the outcome of the reflecting working group will be much more detailed, systematic regarding the multinational file. What we're looking here, what we're proposing for the Secretariat and the help of the evaluation body is a summary of a guideline to help and guide the state parties where they have multinational files, where we see conspiracy and differences in the file that's been submitted from different state parties. And this information already existed. They are existed from the evaluation body for the previous different years. Those information are there. All we're asking the Secretariat, with the help of the evaluation body, to have few pages, a guideline to guide these state parties. We are not asking something new to prepare. The information is already there, and they are just scattered. So we are hoping the Secretariat and the evaluation body to have a few pages of a guideline to help the state parties' multinational files to be more consistent and more clear. Thank you, Madam Chair.
Thank you, Kuwait. I now recognize Kazakhstan.
Thank you, Madam Chair. For time saving, I will try to be very brief. The consideration of the nomination this year during these sessions, especially multinational files, shows that in some cases, there is very difficult to propose joint safeguarding measures for the countries. It's a very difficult issue, and we observed it at least in two files during this session. That's why my delegation would like to share the concern raised by the delegation of Japan. Thank you.
Thank you, Kazakhstan. I now recognize Jamaica.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Jamaica wishes to support in principle the amendment proposed by Switzerland, also noting the concern that Japan has raised. But at the same time, we would like to stress the importance of guidelines rather than instructions in this regard. And if we take note of this, then we shouldn't have a problem going forward in terms of supporting this amendment. So we would like to add our names to Switzerland, Côte d'Ivoire, and Kuwait.
Thank you, Jamaica.
Thank you, Madam Chair.
I now recognize Czechia.
Merci, Madame la Présidente. Nous comprenons fort bien le sens de ce libellé qui va aussi dans le sens de notre intervention qu'on a eue un petit peu avant ce point. Et on voudrait tout à fait se porter co-auteur de ce libellé et peut-être aussi demander au secrétariat si c'est possible déjà de préparer ce genre de notes d'orientation. Et on souscrit tout à fait à ce qui a été dit, surtout par Monsieur l'ambassadeur du Kuwait. Je crois que nous avons besoin de quelque chose de pratique et assez tôt. Je préférerais que ce soit le secrétariat qui, bien sûr, avec l'aide d'organes d'évaluation et tous les États membres, pourquoi pas, puissent travailler sur ces notes. Merci, Madame la Présidente.
Thank you, Chekia. Now, I understand that the Secretariat may have some comments to make on this amendment. Mr. Curtis?
Thank you, Madam Chairperson. I would just like to give some clarifications on what is happening with the overall reflection, because I think there's a feeling that it's very far away. In fact, our next meeting will be the Intergovernmental Working Group for the overall reflection in June of next year, it is foreseen. Intergovernmental meeting. There will be an expert meeting before that. And that has several decisions behind it.
including reviewing, re-examining criteria 2. We have a decision last year asking us to change the way multinational files are joined. And my concern, and so we, this will now be the priority for our work next year, starting with an expert meeting in the first part of the year in June, the open-ended intergovernmental working group, that which will then report to the next session of the committee in December. So in fact, it is not a long process. We are now coming into the end of the process, and we've taken some delays this year because of the COVID-19 pandemic. So there's a workflow issue, but there's also a logical issue, because if the intergovernmental working group decides to change some of the criteria, if the intergovernmental working group also looks at the evaluation process, everything we write in this guidance note could become obsolete. So we feel that, and we fully understand and support the idea of a guidance note. We are not against it. We feel there's a problem of timing, and perhaps it might be positive to write about, to prepare the guidance note for the preparation of multinational files in order to improve their quality, taking into account the overall reflection on the listing mechanisms. And I will probably have a similar comment on the next proposal. I did hear some comments that the reflection is long and is taking long. It is highly unlikely that we would be able to do any guidance notes prior to this reflection, since the reflection process is really the next item on our work schedule. Thank you, Madam Chairperson.
Thank you, Mr. Curtis. Kuwait has raised a point of order. Go ahead, Kuwait.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Madam Chair, as I stated before, could you please, and the secretaries, whenever, just to be fair and be professional, with our colleagues, Japan stated, they have an opinion on that draft amendment. I think it would be wise to have what Japan said to conflicted in the decision, even though we submit and they have different opinion, but I think it's fair for them to have their point of view on the screen, so the other state parties can look at it and and compare what they are. I mean, what's in which side they are feel it's better, Japan side, our side. There is no, So just to be more practical and clear, before the secretariat take the floors, so we can move forward. So from now, please, if any state parties have a suggestion on that in the DR, to be much appreciated if we can see it, to reflect what the ambassadors say, and to be reflected on the draft amendment. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Kuwait. I will now ask Djibouti to take the floor.
Merci, Madame la Présidente. Je vais être bref. En fait, je voulais apporter notre soutien à l'amendement proposé par la Suisse, la Côte d'Ivoire et le Koweït, et dire que j'étais d'avis par les éclaircissements apportés par la délégation de Koweït et les préoccupations de Madame l'ambassadeur de la Côte d'Ivoire. Merci, Madame la Présidente.
Thank you. Japan has asked for the floor. I will, however, ask Japan to provide us with the text of the amendment they propose, and that it can go ahead and take the floor at this point.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Originally, I had a slightly different idea. But after hearing the clarification by the secretariat, maybe there are two options here. One option would be to replace the part invite the secretariat and the following. Instead of saying that, invite the open-ended intergovernmental working group on global reflection to discuss the preparations of multinational files in order to improve their quality. That was the original suggestion that I had in mind. But after hearing the views, clarifications from the secretariat, perhaps we can simply add at the very end of the current proposal by Switzerland after quality, maybe we can simply add taking into account the global reflection on the listing mechanism. That could also be okay from our perspective. Thank you.
Thank you, thank you. I now recognize Saudi Arabia.
Thank you, Madam Chair. This is just to echo Switzerland, Cote d'Ivoire, and Kuwait. We would like Saudi Arabia to add its name to the amendments.
Thank you. I recognize Switzerland. Please go ahead, Switzerland.
Thank you, Mrs. President. We would like to thank the distinguished colleague of Japan for his suggestion, which is fully in line with our reflection, and we totally greet it. Thank you.
Thank you, Switzerland. Brazil, you may take the floor.
Thank you, Madam Chair. We will support strongly the Japanese amendment to this Swiss, Cote d'Ivoire, Kuwait, and Jamaica proposal. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Okay, another member wishes to take the floor. It's Poland. Go ahead, Poland.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Poland wishes to be also added as a supporter of this amendment. Thank you.
Thank you. Other members indicating? We have Morocco. Go ahead, Morocco. You may take the floor.
Merci, Madame la Présidente. C'est juste pour dire que nous soutenons de notre côté cet amendement. Merci.
Thank you. Cote d'Ivoire.
Merci, Madame la Présidente. Je suis favorable à l'amendement que le Japon vient d'apporter à notre amendement. Donc, la phrase qu'ils ajoutent favorise bien ce que nous pensions et nous soutenons aussi cet amendement du Japon. Merci, Madame la Présidente.
Thank you, Cote d'Ivoire. Kazakhstan.
Thank you, Madam Chairperson. We just would like to be added to the list for Japan comment. Thank you.
Thank you. Sweden?
Thank you, Madam Chairperson. We would like to thank Switzerland for introducing this amendment in the first place and also Japan for the amendment, which we can agree with. So we support the amendment as shown on the screen. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Sweden. Sri Lanka. Go ahead, Sri Lanka.
Yeah, we would like to support the Japanese amendment. Thank you.
Thank you, Botswana.
The same, Madam Chair.
Thank you, Kuwait.
Also, Kuwait would like to their names added with His Excellency, with the Ambassador of Japan, would say it. Thank you.
Thank you, Panama.
Thank you, Madam Chair. We are also supporting the proposal of Japan. Thank you.
Cameroon. Cameroon, please go ahead. Djibouti.
Merci, Madame la Présidente. La délégation s'associe et soutient l'amendement proposé par le Japon aussi. Merci.
Thank you. Is Panama there?
Yes. Oh, no, but I'm not requesting again.
Go ahead, Panama. Okay. All right, thank you. Colleagues, now we are ready to adopt paragraph 9 as amended by Switzerland and Japan. Are there any objections?
Sorry, Madam Chair.
Tim? Madam Chair.
Madam Chair, perhaps it might be useful to use the same methodology to ask those who wish to support the Japan amendment to leave their hands up, and those who are not taking the floor to support the Japan amendment to withdraw their hands. In this case, we will know if we have on the list asking Poland, Cameroon, Jamaica, Morocco, Netherlands. And Czechia, Botswana, Poland. So Cameroon, are we, Madam Chair, I understand I'm reading now to see which states support the amendment of Japan, and I read Cameroon, Jamaica, Morocco, Netherlands, Saudi Arabia, Czechia, Botswana, Poland, Panama, Peru, Morocco again, Republic of Korea, Brazil, Rwanda. No. Thank you, Madam Chair.
Thank you, Mr. Curtis. Now we're ready to adopt paragraph 9 as amended by Switzerland and Japan. Are there any objections? I see no objections. Adopted. Colleagues, we now move to new paragraph 9, introduced by Switzerland. Switzerland, do you wish to take the floor?
Thank you. Just briefly, cet amendement fait écho à différentes remarques de l'organe d'évaluation qui salue les candidatures mettant en évidence la durabilité environnementale et qui rappelle l'importance de montrer les liens et les contributions de la sauvegarde du patrimoine culturel immatériel à la durabilité. Comme l'ambassadeur suisse l'a dit, nous félicitons le travail du secrétariat avec le soutien des Pays-Bas pour Dive into ICH, avec les relations des éléments inscrits aux 17 objectifs du développement durable. Notre idée ici, c'est de mener une réflexion pour intégrer les liens au ODD et les contributions possibles directement dans les candidatures pour faciliter la reprise par le secrétariat et pour sensibiliser les États soumissionnaires. Il s'agirait ici de proposer une réflexion pour cette intégration des ODD. Merci.
Thank you. Does any committee wish to take the floor? Any committee member wish to take the floor? Kuwait, you may take the floor.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Just suggesting to follow the same mechanism as before. If everyone, just to save the time, if everyone in favor, we can move forward.
I understand that the Secretariat may have some comments to make on this amendment. Please go ahead, Mr. Curtis.
Madam Chair, before I would do that, I do see we have the floor asked for by Botswana and Japan.
Botswana.
I saw Jamaica, but they withdrew.
Botswana, please go ahead.
No, we were raising our hands to support them. And
Mr. Curtis, would you wish to go ahead now?
I believe Japan would like the floor, Madam Chair.
Japan, please go ahead.
Madam Chair, no, we support the process proposed now. Thank you.
Thank you, Japan. Mr. Curtis, you may take the floor. Thank you.
Madam Chair, I also would like to thank the delegate of Switzerland for their remarks on the work we've done with the dive, and we fully support, of course, the aims of this. There is, again, as we said for the last one, we will be working next year on the overall reflection for the listing mechanisms, which we will present to the committee next year. This is at risk of creating a parallel process where we will be presenting an overall reflection to the committee, and then we will be presenting a side reflection on a specific part of the listing mechanisms. It might make more sense, or and also more conducive to the work, to have a slight amendment to request the Secretariat to include a reflection on this subject within the overall reflection process and present it to the committee. What I'm saying is that we can add this to the reflection on the list, present it as one item to the next committee as part of the overall reflection, and this will be integrated into it, rather than have a parallel reflection process going on.
Thank you, Mr. Curtis. Does any committee member wish to take the floor in light of the explanation given by the Secretariat? Sweden, could you go ahead, please? Take the floor. Thank you.
Thank you, Madam Chairperson. And we would like to thank Switzerland for introducing this very important issue. But we also understand the constraints from this that the, has been explained by the Secretariat regarding the already ongoing reflection. So we would like to support the amendment, but with the slight amendment by the Secretariat, so that this will be included in the current reflection on the listing mechanism. I don't know if the wording is already there. But we would support that with the amendment by the Secretariat. Thank you.
Thank you, Sweden. Jamaica?
Thank you, Madam Chair. Jamaica would also like to support the amendment by Sweden and are grateful for the intervention made by the Secretariat and would therefore support the position and the wording to that amendment as provided by the Secretariat. Thank you, Madam Chair.
Thank you, Jamaica. Brazil?
Thank you, Madam Chair. It's just to endorse this amendment proposed by the Secretariat and endorsed by Sweden and Jamaica. I think now the para 9 is okay for us. We can support it. Thank you.
Thank you, Brazil. Can we now go to the methodology, Mr. Curtis? Those of you, could you go ahead, Mr. Curtis? You may want to.
Thank you, Madam Chair. I would just remind, at the moment I see four hands risen, Poland, Netherlands, Kuwait, and, well, I see four hands written in Saudi Arabia. The methodology then would consist in asking those. So we'll start with, firstly, the overall paragraph by Switzerland. Those countries that support the overall paragraph as proposed by Switzerland, please keep your hands up. I read Poland, Netherlands, Kuwait, Saudi Arabia, Czechia, Djibouti, Japan, Republic of Korea, Sri Lanka, Jamaica, Botswana, Kazakhstan, Peru, Morocco, Cote d'Ivoire, Sweden,
and Panama.
China. And then, Madam Chair, perhaps to see if our proposal, which has the second part, the amendment or the proposed amendment with Secretariat Sweden, Jamaica, Brazil, could all committee members first lower their hands? First, lower your hands, please. It's important, otherwise we don't know which one you have. Okay. Okay, now, perhaps all committee members who support this extra addition,
which reads, in the framework of the global reflection. Okay, I read Netherlands, Kazakhstan, Japan, Cameroon, Switzerland, Brazil, Botswana, Jamaica, Republic of Korea, Rwanda, Poland, Czechia, Sweden, Panama, Sri Lanka, Peru, China, Côte d'Ivoire. Madam Chair, I think Kuwait is asking for a point of order.
Kuwait, recognize.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Madam Chair, I have no issue with, about the suggestion of the Secretariat. Just a clarification from the legal point of view. We are discussing a draft amendment. Can the Secretariat submit a draft amendment? Because if you look at it, it's them, just from the legal point of view. I mean, I mean, as to my knowledge, they explain things, then state parties submit a DA. To me, looking at it, it's the Secretariat. So just from the legal point of view, if that's, you know, legally or not. Thank you, Madam Chair.
Thank you. Mr. Curtis?
Actually, you're right. So in that sense, would it help if we just removed Secretariat there?
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Now we are ready to adopt paragraph 9 as amended by Switzerland and...
Madam Chair?
Yes, go ahead.
Apologies, I see one more supporting state, Saudi Arabia.
Okay. Are there any objections? Or do we adopt as seen on the screen now and the amendments made? I see no objection.
Madam Chair?
Yes.
I see Kuwait has also risen its hand, and I presume it's also to support the amendment. We will add Kuwait.
Okay, good. So we can now adopt as amended. Next, we have now adopted each of the paragraphs. I'm sorry. Just one moment, please. Next paragraph highlighted on the screens, recommending that issues and recommendations from the evaluation body report to be taken into consideration in the ongoing global reflection on the listing mechanisms. Are there any objections? There are no objections. We can adopt. Adopted. We have now adopted each of the paragraphs, and we need to adopt the decision as a whole. Seeing no objections, I therefore declare decision 15.8 adopted. Colleagues, we are now ready to move on to item 9. Number of files submitted for the 2020 and 2021 cycles, and number of files that can be treated in the 2022 and 2023 cycles. Since 2009, when the committee examined the first nomination files, and at successive sessions, the committee discussed the issues related to number of files extensively. I understand that it was also the subject of lengthy debates during the last session of General Assembly in September this year, which resulted in a recommendation addressed to us, the committee. The challenge here, colleagues, is to reach a decision that would find the right balance between the spirit of inclusiveness of the 2003 Convention and the workload related with the nomination process. Let me now give the floor to Mr. Curtis to give us more details. Mr. Secretary, the floor is yours. Thank you.
Thank you, Madam Chairperson. The issues related to the number of files have a long history, as just mentioned by the Chairperson, and they are complex with many details. And I will try here only to summarize the main points.
Je t'entendais pas. Ça va?
Palestine, could you? Thank you. I will try best to summarize the main points here, particularly because the details can be found in the working documents. Firstly, the working document for this item provides an overview of the files submitted for the 2020 and 2021 cycles. It is reported that a warning raised for the 2019 cycle has been confirmed under the 2021 cycle. In other words, an unusually high number of files, including multinational files, and from a higher than normal number of submitting states, means that the annual ceiling and priority system no longer seem to be sustainable. Mindful of the importance of multinational files for international cooperation, as well as the need to continue the efforts to improve upon the geographical balance of the lists, the Secretariat decided to include 60 files in the 2021 cycle, although the request was for 50. This problem was again discussed at length during the 8th session of the General Assembly in September 2020. While welcoming the goodwill of the Secretariat to increase the number of files for the 2021 cycle to 60, the Assembly emphasized the need to step up the efforts to render the list more geographically representative, balanced, and culturally diversified. To that end, the General Assembly recommended that the committee consider the possibility of increasing the number of files to include all the files submitted by states parties for 2022 and 2023 cycles. The issue of annual number of files touch upon a series of interrelated issues that are fundamental to the Convention, such as the spirit of inclusiveness, the search for balanced lists, but also the credibility of the mechanism and the workload of all concerned. It is the opinion of the Secretariat that any reflections that might lead to a sustainable change in the number of overall files must be undertaken carefully in conjunction with the global reflection process on the listing mechanisms as initiated by the 13th session of the committee. At the same time, the experience of the evaluation body and the committee in evaluating and examining 60 files under 2021 cycle will surely have to be taken into account. In other words, whilst the Secretariat could, if and only if reinforced with extra resources, increase the number of files we process, the evaluation of the files under the current system will not be improved by merely adding extra evaluators. And this is because the evaluation body members must reach consensus on each criterion. If the annual ceiling were to be changed to include a high number of files, the overall listing system would need to be drastically changed. It would necessarily imply lightening the evaluation process, including the criteria. Moreover, if the committee were to continue with the annual ceiling system, different ways of managing the priority system will need to be reflected on and devised. So in the meantime, an intermediary solution needs to be sought. The committee may adopt an approach to that for use for 2021 cycles that could be envisaged. That is to include at least 50 files under both 2022 and 2023, while ensuring that all files under priority zero are included. If the number of files under priority zero alone exceeds the ceiling of 50 files, the Secretariat then could also consider treating priority one national files from submitting states with no elements inscribed, or priority two
multinational files giving priority to files from states with no national elements inscribed. With this proposal, I finish my presentation. Thank you, Madam Chairperson.
Thank you, Mr. Curtis. I now open the floor. Does anybody wish to take the floor? I understand Sweden wishes to take the floor. Go ahead, Sweden.
Thank you, Madam Chair. As the document shows, we face major challenges when it comes to the number of files that can be examined. And it is of the utmost importance that this problem finds a solution through the reflecting process of the listing mechanism. But right now, it's a fact that the financial and human resources within the Secretariat and the evaluation body are limited. If we try to exceed that limit, it will affect the quality and legitimacy of the evaluation, and by extension, our possibilities of working according to the spirit of the convention. We, all state parties, must take this into account when considering submitting new nominations. Sweden would like to thank the Secretariat for presenting a possible intermediary solution. Within the proposal in the draft decision, we also want to underline the importance of the possibilities for treating files connected to the priorities under point 1 and 2 in paragraph 34 of the operational directives. These priorities include the urgent safeguarding list, international assistance, the register of good safeguarding practices, and the multinational files. These mechanisms are of fundamental importance for this convention. Thank you.
Thank you, Sweden. Czechia?
J'espère que vous m'entendez. Nous remercions le secrétariat pour son analyse de la situation actuelle et pour sa proposition d'augmenter à 60 le nombre de dossiers examinés en 2021. Nous sommes conscients de la gravité de la situation actuelle concernant les dossiers en attente pour le cycle suivant et nous espérons qu'une solution durable découlera de la réflexion globale qui est menée actuellement sur les mécanismes d'inscription. Car nous nous rendons bien compte que le secrétariat, l'organe d'évaluation et le comité lui-même sont à la limite de leurs possibilités et c'est pourquoi s'efforcer d'augmenter encore le nombre de dossiers qui seront examinés lors des sessions futures du comité n'est pas possible. D'ores et déjà, l'inscription des dossiers nous prend bien trop de temps. Un temps précieux que nous voudrions consacrer davantage au rapport sur l'état de sauvegarde, aux mesures de sauvegarde, à la participation des communautés et aux autres aspects de la mise en œuvre de notre convention, et aux initiatives intéressantes, comme par exemple dans le domaine du PCI, dans l'environnement urbain ou dans son rapport au patrimoine immobilier. Pour conclure, nous espérons que la réflexion globale nous proposera une solution à ce défi acceptable à tous et nous remercions le secrétariat pour la solution intermédiaire pour le cycle à venir. Merci, Madame la Présidente.
Thank you, Czechia. Japan?
Thank you, Madame Chair. First of all, let me welcome the constructive endeavors of the Secretariat to increase the number of the files examined for the 2021 cycle from 50 to 60. At the same time, we are also concerned about the accumulation of backlog files, which indicates a serious issue. We still have many potential files waiting for inscription in Japan as well, and we need a fundamental review of the evaluation system. In fact, at this moment alone, I'm under pressure from some of the people in Japan. But on the other hand, we have to take into account the working capacity of the secretariat and the evaluation body who actually perform the work. So this is a, you know, this is the relationship between the requirements and the amount of work. I think many delegations have already mentioned this, and the reflection group, you know, will need to look into this. But so at this moment, we cannot really increase the number of files to be examined so much. That is why we need to look at the rules again to find the right path towards the future. Thank you, Madam Chair.
Thank you, Japan. Azerbaijan.
Merci, Madame la Présidente. La délégation d'Azerbaïdjan note avec inquiétude la situation du nombre de dossiers qui seront traités dans le cycle 2021 pour le système de priorité établi dans la directive opérationnelle a pour la première fois connu une crise. Cette situation doit être traitée d'urgence car elle laisse l'un des plus importants mécanismes d'inscription, donc les candidatures multinationales, presque en dehors du plafond des dossiers à évaluer. Il s'agit en effet d'une situation très préoccupante compte tenu des efforts que les États déploient pour préparer et soumettre de tels dossiers. Notre délégation a une question posée au secrétariat concernant les cycles 2022-2023. Nous voudrions nous référer à la résolution 8GA.11 de la 8e session de l'Assemblée générale tenue en septembre de cette année qui recommande au comité, dans le cadre de processus de réflexion sur le mécanisme d'inscription, d'envisager la possibilité d'augmenter ce nombre pour inclure tous les dossiers soumis par les États parties pour le cycle 2022-2023. Nous comprenons cependant sur la base du document de travail soumis qu'en raison des difficultés liées à la charge de travail, il ne sera pas possible d'inclure tous les dossiers et le secrétariat est prêt à faire preuve de flexibilité en 2022-2023 et inclure les candidatures des États n'ayant pas d'éléments inscrits et les dossiers multinationaux, tout en donnant la priorité aux dossiers des pays n'ayant pas d'éléments nationaux inscrits. Notre question est de savoir qu'est-ce que va se passer avec les dossiers multinationaux, donc les États soumissionnaires ne comptent pas parmi des États sans aucun élément national inscrit. Considérant que leur chance est de bénéficier de la flexibilité soit encore plus faible et tout en cherchant à comprendre le secrétariat, nous voudrions suggérer de supprimer cette partie du paragraphe 9 du projet de décision. Enfin, nous pensons qu'un débat ad hoc pourrait éventuellement être organisé afin de réfléchir à la situation et de proposer des pistes à suivre au comité lors de sa prochaine session. Je vous remercie.
Thank you, Berjazan. Switzerland.
Madame la Présidente, la Suisse salue l'analyse réalisée par le secrétariat quant au cycle 2020 et 2021 de soumission des dossiers et en partage les conclusions. La conciliation de l'accroissement du nombre de demandes, des attentes des États soumissionnaires et du système de priorité en place représente un défi complexe. Vu les capacités et ressources du secrétariat, de l'organe d'évaluation et du comité, une attention particulière doit être portée au maintien de conditions permettant de garantir la bonne qualité du traitement des dossiers et partant la crédibilité du travail de notre comité. Nous comprenons la volonté exprimée par certains États parties d'intensifier les efforts pour tendre vers des listes géographiquement plus équilibrées et culturellement plus diversifiées. Toutefois, il nous semble important de ne pas prendre de décision hâtive concernant le nombre de dossiers pour le cycle 2022-2023. D'une part, il convient de mener à terme le processus de réflexion sur les mécanismes d'inscription. Il est important de considérer aussi ces résultats avant tout changement de fond du modèle actuel. D'autre part, à court terme, il convient d'éviter la saturation de notre système. La Suisse soutient en conséquence la proposition transitoire proposée par le secrétariat. Je vous remercie de votre attention.
Thank you, Switzerland. Brazil?
Gracias, señora presidenta. El número de candidaturas sigue creciendo de forma constante y esto solo podemos verlo con enorme satisfacción, ya que es la demostración más clara del éxito de esta convención y de la visibilidad del patrimonio cultural y material. Sabemos que la Secretaría y el órgano evaluador están atentos a la necesidad de reducir el desequilibrio en la distribución geográfica de los elementos de la lista. Y las propias directivas operacionales ya contemplan en el parágrafo 34 de las prioridades a ser aplicadas, con la precedencia a los países que tienen uno o ningún elemento en las candidaturas multinacionales. Pero también estamos conscientes que esto no puede significar una limitación sistemática de las candidaturas de los países que ya cuentan con elementos en las listas, en las varias listas. Por lo tanto, un aumento del número de las candidaturas analizadas se hará necesario, tarde o temprano. Sin embargo, este aumento no se puede hacer a expensas de la calidad y del nivel técnico de las cuales se realizan hoy los exámenes de las candidaturas presentadas. Como no es razonable desear que el órgano evaluador pueda tratar un número de candidaturas muy superior a sus capacidades operacionales, nos parece que las posibles soluciones pasen por la construcción de capacidades y la cooperación técnica en el ámbito del patrimonio cultural, lo que volvería más fluido el proceso de evaluación. Como tuvimos la oportunidad de subrayar antes, reconocemos que para esta reunión el órgano evaluador ha realizado un inmenso esfuerzo de trabajo y lo felicitamos una vez más. Sabemos que la presentación incompleta de la documentación de candidaturas es un factor que sistemáticamente retrasa los ritmos de trabajo y de evaluación. Por todo esto, nos parece que la propuesta de decisión presentada por el secretariado, la solución intermedia, que Brasil apoya decididamente, sea un buen punto de partida para llegar a un compromiso definitivo, pero necesitamos también invertir en construcción de capacidades y cooperación técnica como forma de simplificar el trabajo y acelerarlo sin perjuicio de las excelencias de la labor de evaluación. Gracias, señora presidenta.
Thank you, Brazil. Netherlands?
Thank you, Madam Chair. We would like to echo the words of the delegation of Czechia and many more speakers before us. We know this is a very important point to increase the examinations of more files, but we know this is very important to all the states and for the communities, but we think it's better to have this as a part of the global reflection on the listing mechanisms, and also to see what the outcomes of this reflection is, and to have then more balanced files. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Poland?
Thank you very much, Madam Chair. Just to be very brief, and I just don't want to repeat what have been said before me, but first of all, I want to thank the Secretariat for this very detailed report regarding the number of files submitted for this cycle and the next cycles. And I would like to share some thoughts that we have over while reading this report. And I know that there might be some other countries as well who are wondering whether the increase of number of files for the next cycle will affect all the actions, like, for example, capacity building in the process over the next years. And this is my question to the Secretariat. Maybe Secretariat will be so nice, so kind and answer to this one. Thank you so much. And maybe this will help us with the future decision. Thank you.
Thank you. I will ask Mr. Curtis to take the floor, please.
Thank you. Thank you, and I thank the delegate of Poland for her question, and I believe there was a question from the delegation of Azerbaijan earlier. If I understand, the delegation of Azerbaijan was asking what happens to files who would not include a country that has no element already inscribed. Well, within the framework, of course, we would do as much as we can, but yes, for sure, those files would then, given our capacities, would probably not be treated in that cycle. Again, 2021 is the first time ever we found ourselves in a situation where multinational files were not able to be inscribed. But this is a proposal we made to go for a way forward. As to the question from the delegation of Poland, I can only say, as I said also during the GA, there's no doubt if we have to give more resources to processing files, we are taking resources away from other parts of our work, including capacity building. So it's a resource question, it's a resource allocation question. If you increase in one side, you must decrease somewhere else, unless you have access to extra resources. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Curtis. Botswana?
Thank you, Madam Chair. Just want to find clarity in terms of the number of files that a state party can submit under the multinational files. Because the observation that we made is that some state parties can make many submissions under the multinational files. And this, in a way, affects negatively the quality of the files that are submitted. Because in this cycle that we've been in, we've noticed that some multinational files were not able to satisfy most of the criteria, probably because there were a lot of them submitted in the same cycle. Thank you, Madam Chair.
Thank you. I will now give the floor to Austria.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you.
The Austrian delegation would join the previous delegations to commend the Secretariat for the excellent document on the number of files for the upcoming cycles. It has provided a very clear explanation concerning the challenges for the evaluation process. If we further increase the number of dossiers to be examined, risking even the collapse of our system. Thus, we highly appreciate your efforts dealing with an increased number of files in 21, especially knowing full well the high workload that this implies. It is a pleasure to see that there is an ever-growing interest in intangible cultural heritage, the convention and nominations, but this increased interest has raised a number of issues and concerns which were also addressed at the 8th General Assembly in September. One of these concerns relates to the growing amount of backlogged files. As the Secretariat clearly elaborates, a larger number of members of the evaluation body, or even splitting it, is not a desirable solution. We support the Secretariat's suggestion to continue with the current procedure for evaluation on an interim basis until the reflections on the listing mechanism have been completed. CAs to be examined annually, as well as an evaluation body that ensures that the coherence and quality of the future cycles. And most importantly, we also should keep in mind the central aspects of the convention, like safeguarding and capacity building. Thank you.
Thank you. Colleagues, let us now move to the decision. Please refer to document 9 and its draft decision in paragraph 14. Can we see it on the screen, please? May I ask the committee to adopt draft decision 15.9? As shown on the screen.
Madam Chair?
Go ahead, Mr. Curtis. Go ahead, you may take the floor.
I believe we did receive an amendment on this decision. We've received, as was announced, an amendment from Kuwait. So we have to go power by power. Oh, sorry, I thought you wanted to adopt as a whole. My apologies. If we go para by para, it's fine. Thank you.
Paragraph 1, citing the document we have examined. Do I see any objections? I see no objection. Adopted. Paragraph 2, recalling our previous decisions. I see no objection. Adopted. Paragraph 3, considering the limited capacity of the committee and the secretariat. No objection. Adopted. Paragraph 4, further considering the limited capacity of the evaluation body, given its composition and working method. Do I see any objection? I see no objection. Adopted. Paragraph 6, decide to set the number of files to be treated for the 2022 and 2023 cycle at least 50. I understand that Kuwait tabled an amendment on this paragraph. Kuwait, do you want to explain your amendment?
Thank you, Madam Chair. Yes, please. First of all, Madam Chair, let me thank the Secretariat for the brave decision they took to increase the files from 50 to 60. And to me, that was a major step forward to solve, you know, a temporary for the short-term solution. I also, you know, understand that the global reflection on the listing mechanism is ongoing, and hopefully after that, we will have a permanent solution. But quite we think, you know, the logic behind our draft amendment is based on three things. First of all, I'm echoing what happened in the General Assembly regarding the cycles, the 22 cycles, where we had, you know, a lot of interest from the state parties to increase 5% or 10% of the files to be evaluated. But was the decision of the General Assembly, it's not the place to increase it, it's the committee responsibility. So what I'm echoing what's happened in the General Assembly. The second point, Madam Chair, as you look from the website of the ICH, we have over 160 files backlog for 46 countries. And I know for the global reflection, we will have hopefully, you know, permanent, but we're trying to help, you know, a minor change that's, you know, going from the 50 proposed to 60, same as been done for the 21 cycle. And Madam Chair, also let me emphasize, you know, in this cycle, we had about, if I'm not mistaken, 7 files that's been withdrawn. Those 7 files, even more than 10%, were being done in this convention. And those files have been done. I mean, most of the work has been done. Those 7 files, you know, majority of the work has been done. And I think increasing from 50 to 60 will help the state parties that who are, you know, withdraw their files with few changes need to be done to be presented in the coming, to have a chance to be presented in the coming future. So what's Kuwait is proposing, it's a minor change. Like I heard my colleagues in the beginning, they are with the minor change, not a major change. So I think, you know, this is a minor change. Thank you, Madam Chair.
Thank you, Kuwait. Committee members, do you have any comments on this? Mr. Curtis, you may wish to comment.
No, I see Saudi Arabia and Morocco.
Go ahead, Saudi Arabia. The floor is yours.
Yes, Madam Chair, we would like to support Kuwait's amendment. Thank you.
Japan.
Morocco, the floor is yours.
Merci, Madame la Présidente. Je souhaite appuyer l'amendement du Kuwait. Et pour cela, j'aimerais bien me référer à nos débats intenses et compliqués qui ont eu lieu pendant la 8e session de l'Assemblée générale en septembre 2020, et pendant laquelle on a salué la volonté du secrétariat de porter à 60 le nombre de dossiers pour le cycle 2021. Je sais que la tâche est très compliquée pour l'organe d'évaluation, que la charge de travail est énorme, mais comme on l'a fait pour le cycle 2021, on aimerait bien reconduire donc cette mesure pour le cycle 2022-2023. Et comme l'a dit M. l'ambassadeur du Koweït, c'est un changement minime et on verra par la suite pour les cycles à venir si on maintiendra ou si on reviendra selon le travail ou la réflexion sur les mécanismes d'inscription qui est en cours. Merci, Madame la Présidente.
Thank you. Japan?
Thank you, Madam Chair. It's a bit difficult for me to argue this in a very proper way, but on the one hand, we are not against the idea of having a number 60 here. But according to the original formulation, it was at least 50, and you will have some flexibility clauses in paragraph 8 and 9. And this is, in a way, with a view to increasing the number up to 60 or something like that. Now, if the basis is 60, we are, in a way, we are giving an impression that it can be something like 70 with the flexibility clauses in paragraph 8 and 9. That is a little bit, too much on the one side. So my suggestion at least would be to delete this at least. Well, I can go along with the idea that we have 60 as a upper limit. But since we have flexibility clauses after this, at least, you know, this place at least has to go. And beyond that, let me have some time to think about this, but 60, no, we should have a general understanding that 60 is more or less the maximum we can go at this moment. And to increase the number more than that, we have to wait for the reflection group. But in my heart, I'm not against the increase of number. So I'm sorry for this complicated statement, but 60 is probably the target to go at this moment. Thank you.
Thank you. Djibouti?
Merci, Madame la Présidente. C'était juste pour soutenir la proposition de Koweït. Merci beaucoup.
Thank you. Mr. Curtis? I should recognize Czechia. Thank you.
Merci, Madame la Présidente. Il nous semble un peu difficile de suivre l'amendement du Koweït sur ce paragraphe compte tenu de la discussion qu'on vient d'avoir et des explications du secrétariat. Je crois qu'il nous a montré sa bonne volonté d'essayer de traiter 60 dossiers en cycle 2021. Et il nous a aussi dit qu'ils vont faire de l'air mieux avec l'organe d'évaluation pour traiter les d'autres dossiers prioritaires au-delà des 50. D'ailleurs, comme notre distingué délégué du Koweït nous l'a dit, son changement est minime et nous pensons que si nous revenons au wording initial avec au moins 50 dossiers par cycle, si ce sera un petit peu plus, on pourra aller jusqu'à 60 si jamais ils sont dans la priorité, et ça donne quand même une marge de manœuvre au secrétariat, à l'organe d'évaluation. Donc nous serions favorables de garder le texte comme il était initialement. Merci.
Thank you. Azerbaijan?
Merci,
Merci, Madame la Présidente. C'était juste pour dire que nous soutenons la proposition de COVID. Merci.
Thank you. Peru?
Gracias, señora presidenta. Nosotros apoyamos también la propuesta de Kuwait.
Thank you. I will now give the floor to Mr. Curtis.
Madam, I have no need to add to the debate at this stage. Just to explain that we have now on the screen the original amendment proposed by Kuwait, Saudi Arabia, Morocco, Djibouti, Peru. We have an addition by Japan to remove the at least and then check that has stated it wishes to stay at 50. Thank you.
Members, please raise your hands if you agree with the proposal.
Switzerland, members, I believe, is asking for the floor.
Go ahead, Switzerland. We recognize you.
Thank you, Chair. This is to support the proposal of Czechia, and in the eventuality of an exception of the amendment of Kuwait, Saudi Arabia, Morocco, Djibouti, and Peru, we would like to support the amendment of Japan.
Switzerland? I'm sorry. Brazil?
Thank you, Madam Chair. Brazil supports the original wording, but if the committee decides to endorse the Kuwaiti proposal, then we will support the Japanese proposal to strike out the word at least. Thank you.
Netherlands?
Thank you, Madam Chair. We would like to support a suggestion made by Czechia to go back to the original wording. Thank you.
Thank you. Sweden?
We also like to support the original wording and the proposal from Czechia, and in second hand, the proposal from Japan. Thank you.
Thank you. Panama?
Thank you, Madam President. I'm going to talk in Spanish this time. Yo realmente estoy confundida. Porque estamos hablando de nominaciones para la lista en necesidad de ayuda de salvaguardia urgente, cuyas solicitudes son de más de $100,000. O sea que estamos poniendo un tope de 50 o 60 nominaciones para casos de urgencia, solamente este párrafo 6. ¿Es así, señora Presidente?
May I ask Mr. Curtis?
Yeah. Just for the Honorable Delegate of Panama, no, I think this is not related to situations or emergencies or to only the urgent safeguarding. This is just for all, as we did just the last 2 days, for all files submitted, be they representative list, urgent safeguarding list, good safeguarding practices, or international assistance above 100,000. Thank you.
Si me permite, señora presidenta, para seguir entonces, si me da la palabra.
Go ahead, Mr. Curtis. Mr. Curtis, you wanted to make a comment, further comment?
No, I just answered the question, I believe, to Panama.
Panama, please go ahead.
Gracias, señora presidenta. Entonces, si tomamos en cuenta que sea 50 o 60 lo que pongamos como tope para las nominaciones, nos encontramos con que en el punto 7 siguiente vamos a decidir que si uno por cada estado miembro que son que presente, estaríamos hablando que de los 180 estados miembros de la convención serían 90 por año. Entonces nos parece a nosotros que poner en esta etapa, en este momento, un tope de 50 o 60 realmente no es realista. Por lo tanto, no nos parece que esta enmienda, como está presentada, pueda prosperar. Gracias.
Thank you. Thank you. Dear colleagues, can I ask those of you in support of the proposal of Czechia to raise your hands? Mr. Curtis, could you please identify those countries, those members?
We see Switzerland, Netherlands, Sweden, Republic of Korea, Brazil. I believe those are the countries. I see no more hands being raised, Madam Chair.
Thank you. Please lower your hands. Colleagues, those who have their hands raised, will you please lower your hands? Can I ask those of you in support of the proposal of Kuwait to raise your hands? Mr. Curtis, could you identify those members?
I read Saudi Arabia, Peru, Morocco, Djibouti, Azerbaijan, and China. And Côte d'Ivoire, Sri Lanka. Okay. I see no more hands, Madam Chair.
Thank you, Mr. Curtis. One moment, please. Colleagues, maybe the Japanese amendment will get us out of this. Please raise your hands if you agree with the Japanese proposal. Mr. Curtis?
Madam Chair, I read Sweden, Republic of Korea, Netherlands, Switzerland, Japan, Brazil, Cameroon, Czechia, Kazakhstan, China. Kazakhstan is up. Have we put Kazakhstan up? Put Kazakhstan, please. Kazakhstan. I'll reread the list I have, Madam Chair. Sweden, Republic of Korea, Netherlands, Japan, Brazil, Cameroon, Kazakhstan, China, Sri Lanka. Madam Chair, Jamaica as well, for the Japan.
Okay. Just one moment, please.
Madam Chair, could Mr. Curtis read the Japanese amendments, please.
Mr. Curtis, could you please
Madam Chair, I understand. Okay, just to clarify, we have three proposals. It's a little bit confusing. The original red is determined to be at least 50. At least 50. Then Kuwait proposed an amendment of at least 60. Then Japan said we could then remove the at least because of the other paragraphs which give the flexibility to go above, in which case the Japanese proposal is would be read that can be treated as determined to be 60, but not at least 60. Czechia, Nanabako doesn't need to write. Czechia would wish, with those supporting Czechia, to stay at the original of at least 50. Thank you.
I recognize Peru. You wish to take the floor? Peru, do you wish to take the floor? If you do so, please go ahead.
Sí, gracias, Presidenta. Sí, nosotros estamos a favor de la enmienda de tomar los 60, pero no, pero eliminar también, como dice Japón, la frase de al menos.
Kuwait, you wish to take the floor. If you do so, go ahead.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Just wanted to clarify one thing. I'm glad, you know, that a lot of people think the 60 is a reasonable number. Just to make sure that, you know, if we put just 60, then the secretariat has no flexibility. So everyone know the maximum will be 60. So regarding of the scenario, regarding of priorities, they will not be enters in the 22 cycles. So I'm glad, you know, 60 to me is fine, but you know, bear in mind regarding of any circumstances, they cannot increase one nomination according to this decision, like they did in the 21 cycles, where they increased 20% of the number of nomination from 50 to 60, they increased 20%. Just to clarify to my colleagues, because the next parts will depend on this decision. Thank you, Madam Chair.
Thank you, Kuwait. I will now give the floor to Mr. Curtis. You may wish to guide us.
Yeah, Madam Chair, I'll point you just to rule 25.1 on amendments. It seems that we now have three, but two that seem to go together. We have Kuwait plus Japan, which seems to have, according to the countries we have on the screen, quite a lot of support. Then we have the proposal to stay to the original from Czechia. So allow me to read Rule 25. When an amendment to a proposal is moved, the amendment shall be voted on first. When two or more amendments are moved, the committee shall first vote. We are not voting here, but we shall still discuss the amendment deemed by the chairperson to be the furthest removed in substance from the original proposal. Madam Chair, with this in mind, it might be worth first seeing if Kuwait plus Japan together is acceptable, and that, and then we can see from there, because that seems to me as a possible way out, taking 25.1. Thank you. I see Panama and Poland have asked for the floor, Madam Chair. Kuwait is asking for a point of order.
Kuwait?
Yes. Go ahead. With all respect, you know, Madam Chair and the Secretariat, according to the rules and regulation, we cannot have two different amendments and the same countries in voting in both of them. Because, you know, the Japan and the Czech, they are totally different. So the state parties, they either, you know, to go with this one or this or that one. You cannot have, or even with Kuwait, you cannot have voting for this in the same DA where two different opinion and you said they have majority or minority. So, you know, we have three different proposals and three of them are totally different. So the state parties have to think which is the most suitable decision that they favorite and put their names. I don't see, you know, having some people having their names in more than a draft amendment. Thank you, Madam Chair.
Thank you, Kuwait. Panama?
Hablaré en español. Gracias, señora presidenta. Panamá desea apoyar la enmienda de Japón. Gracias.
Thank you, Panama. Poland.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Poland wishes to support amendment presented by Czechia, since we see it that way, that there is no reason that the Secretariat in the next cycle can, the evaluation, but in the next cycle may will to evaluate a bit more than 50. Nomination files. That's why we would like to leave it as it was. Thank you.
Thank you. At this point, I wish to give the floor to Mr. Curtis. Secretariat?
Madam Chair, it seems I understand the intervention by the delegate of Kuwait, although we are not technically in a vote, but nevertheless, it makes sense. I do remember that certain countries said, and I remember Swiss, and I think it was Switzerland and Sweden who said that they supported the Czechia proposal, and then if the Kuwait proposal was maintained, then they support the Japan proposal. So that is addressed as the concerns of the delegate of Kuwait, and since we're not in a vote, this is really to think how to get out of this. Again, perhaps in, according to Rule 25.1, we should first discuss the Kuwait. If the Kuwait is adopted, then countries should decide. So I would say perhaps the Japan proposal should be put to the side until we know whether the Kuwait or Czechia proposal will stay. If the Kuwait proposal stays, then we should discuss the Japan proposal. Thank you.
Thank you, Tim. I recognize Brazil. The floor is yours.
Gracias, Presidenta. No, era solamente para aclarar la posición de Brasil que ya había sido manifestada. Nosotros defendemos la propuesta original. Si después el comité decide que deben ser 60 y no 50, apoyaríamos la propuesta de Japón. Gracias.
Thank you, Brazil. Czechia.
Merci, Madame la Présidente. On aimerait bien trouver une solution consensuelle avec nos collègues du comité. Donc, nous nous demandons si, en retirant notre proposition et en ajoutant à la proposition japonaise le mot maximum, est-ce que ce ne serait pas une solution qui répondrait aux préoccupations soulevées par Kuwait sur la flexibilité pour le secrétariat? Et est-ce que ce ne serait pas l'amendement qui nous conviendrait tous? Donc, ce serait request is determined to be maximum 60 per cycle. Merci.
Thank you. Botswana?
Perhaps I would wait if Kuwait could answer what Czechia has just said. Otherwise, I was going to support Kuwait.
Thank you. Kuwait?
Thank you, Madam Chair. Thank you, Chair, for your question. I think to me, it's important to give the Secretariat flexibility, you know, in the future, like we did in the 21 cycle. Like I said, they went from 20, from 50 to 60. That's because they have flexibility. We don't know what's coming on. Just to have consensus, you know, I'll be, again, you know, I can, instead of having it from 50 to 60, I'll be more comfortable if we can have it, okay, at least to 55. No, we had, you know, this is where, you know, I gave the flexibility to the secretariat, yet at the same time, I feel, you know, the number is increased a little bit. And, you know, consulting with the evaluation, with the expert, a lot of experts I consulted with them, they're saying they can handle that, that increase of 5 hours. They already have done 60. So I think if we can change it to from at least 60 to at least 65, I'll be happy with that. After the approval of the committee, for sure.
Thank you. I will ask Tim.
Just I heard the delegate of Kuwait at the end said 65, but I understand it was 55. At the beginning, he said 55, at least 55. And indeed, at least 55 would give us the flexibility and be an increase. Thank you.
I will recognize Sweden at this time.
Thank you, Madam Chairperson. Well, we wanted to react to the intervention made by Czechia, and in order to reach consensus, which I think we all are working towards, we would see that the Japanese proposal would be the proposition that would meet everyone's concern more or less. We had a very difficult time with the original proposal presented by Kuwait. Now, when it's at least 55, we still have concerns about that. But if this proposal can reach consensus, we're willing to be flexible. But we would either go for the Japanese proposal or the 55. Thank you.
Thank you, Sweden, Peru.
Gracias, Presidenta. Coincido con el delegado que precedió en la palabra, que me precedió en la palabra, en el sentido de que hay que dar flexibilidad a la Secretaría. Poner al menos 60 no significa que haya que subir a 70, como expresó distinguido delegado de Japón. Significa simplemente que la Secretaría deberá procesar al menos 60. Si considera que por los medios con que cuenta no puede exceder los 60, pues se quedará en los 60. Sin embargo, si hay uno más o dos o tres o los que sean necesario procesar y pertinente procesar, la Secretaría tomará la decisión. Entonces, ponerle una camisa de fuerza como máximo 60 es un error. Hay que dejar que la Secretaría use su flexibilidad y su criterio y permitirle procesar por lo menos 60. Nosotros apoyamos claramente la propuesta de Kuwait. Gracias.
Thank you, Peru. I think at this point, I would want to hand the floor to Mr. Curtis, to the Secretariat. Mr. Curtis?
Thank you, Madam Chair. I see that we now have a second proposal by Kuwait, which also allows the flexibility. That flexibility is important because of the following paragraphs by which we apply certain criteria to choose. I understand that, and there's been quite a bit of reference to the work of the Secretariat, and we appreciate that. We feel that this second one with at least 55 can address the concerns that the Ambassador of Japan raised about how we then link it to the following paragraphs. It's a workable solution, and we see this as a way forward. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Curtis. We did very well yesterday with our timing.
Madam Chair?
Go ahead, Mr. Curtis.
We see some hands raised. Perhaps we could now see if there is support for the second proposal of Kuwait through the method we said before.
Yes.
Are the hands now, you may wish to ask committee members, those who wish to support at least 55, to raise their hands.
Those who wish to support at least 55?
Meaning the second Kuwait proposal.
And this is the second Kuwait proposal. Mr. Curtis, could you identify?
Madam Chair, I read Brazil, Botswana, Morocco, Saudi Arabia, Netherlands, Djibouti, Republic of Korea. Sorry, I'm working with my computer. And now I have perhaps one of my, 1 minute. Sweden, Jamaica, China, Czechia, Cote d'Ivoire, Rwanda, Japan, Azerbaijan, Poland, Switzerland, Cameroon, Sri Lanka. It seems to have broad support. Thank you.
I'm asking the Secretariat, could you please clean the text?
Madam Chair, with your permission, I will ask my colleagues, and they just need the time to do it, to remove the previous and to leave the latest proposal by Kuwait, which seems to have the broadest support, and remove all previous amendments, meaning first from Japan, yes. And so it would now read in English, is determined to be at least 55 per cycle. Thank you, Madam Chair.
Thank you, Mr.
I can see, 1 minute. We also have Cameroon and Morocco, and Japan, I believe. Yes, Japan, sorry, is not up.
Thank you, colleagues. Can we now go ahead to adopt paragraph 6? As shown on the screen. I would think so. Paragraph 6, as shown on the screen, adopted. Thank you so much, colleagues. Paragraph 7, also decide that at least one file per submitting state should be processed during the two-year period 2022-2023. Do I have an agreement on this? No objection? Adopted. Paragraph 8, allowing the Secretariat to exercise some flexibility. No objection? Adopted. Paragraph 9, requesting the Secretariat consider the possibility of also treating, according to its resources and those of the evaluation body, priority 1, national files from submitting states with no elements inscribed on any of the list, and priority 2, multinational files, giving priority to files from states with no national elements inscribed. No objection? Adopted. Paragraph 10, inviting states parties to take this decision into account when submitting files. I don't see any objections. Adopted. Paragraph 11, requests the Secretariat to inscribe this agenda item in the 15th session. I see no objection. Adopted. Colleagues, we have now adopted each of the paragraphs, and we need to adopt the decision as a whole. I see no objections, and so I therefore declare decision 15.9 adopted as amended. At this point, I wish to recognize Assistant Director General for Culture, Ernesto Otane. Are you in the house? I need to see you on camera.
I don't know why they don't put me on screen.
How are you?
I am here. I've been here with you all week. It's a pleasure to see you.
I know you wish you were here in Jamaica.
Yes, I do.
Thank you. Colleagues, let us now go back to the item we opened on Monday, item 10, on the establishment of the evaluation body for the 2021 cycle. As I already announced to you on Tuesday this week, the committee has elected new candidates for the evaluation body for the 2021 cycle. Let me remind you of the names of the new members. Mr. Nigel Encalada, Belize expert from Electoral Group 3. Mr. Kirk Tsang Yeo, expert from Electoral Group 4. Syria Trust for Development, accredited NGO from Electoral Group 5B. Once more, I wish to congratulate the new members of the evaluation body for their election. Applause, applause, applause. Now that we have the three new members of the committee, we can select the letter which will allow us to determine the order by which the examination and evaluation of files in the 2021 cycle will be established. Last year, one member of the committee volunteered to choose a letter from a box with pieces of paper, each carrying one of the letters from A to Z. Since we cannot proceed the same way this year, may I ask a member of the Secretariat in Paris to select a letter?
Yes, of course. Thank you, Madam Chairperson. We have prepared a box containing letters of the alphabet from A to Z. I think the camera can see the...
No, we did. Can you put the camera on?
The box, please. Not on ADG.
It's in...
Thank you. It is important that the committee members see the process.
I'm seeing the box, and I'm seeing everything.
Thank you, Madam Chair. We're
seeing everything.
Thank you. So we are proposing to use the precedence, to follow the precedence that we had in one of the earlier committee meetings. So the youngest member of the secretariat, Alice Thibault, will now select a letter before you. Please, Alice, go ahead.
Letter X.
The letter selected is X. Thank you, Madam Chair.
Dear members of the committee, thank you so much, Ms. Oyinata, and your team. It's for Miko and Alice. Okay, thank you. Dear members of the committee, I'm pleased to inform you that the committee will start the evaluation and examination process of the files under the 2021 cycle by letter X. They will then continue by alphabetical order with A, B, etc. Are there any questions or comments before we move to the adoption of the draft decision? I see none. I see none. It seems that we are now ready to proceed with the adoption of the draft decision. I ask you to refer to document 10 and its draft decision. In paragraph 10, I'm just asking for the draft decision to be put up on the screens. May I ask the committee to adopt draft decision 15.10 as a whole, as shown on the screens? Are there any objections? I see no objection. I therefore declare decision 15.10 adopted. We will now move on to item 11, date and venue of the 16th session of the committee. Please refer to document 11 and its draft decision. I was informed that the secretariat has not received any invitation from committee members to host the committee's 16th session in its territory. This is not surprising as the COVID-19 pandemic continues to give uncertainties for individuals and state authorities. It is evident that today no state has the necessary visibility to know if it can honor such a commitment in 2021. Let me invite the secretary to provide some additional information concerning the venue, but also the dates. Mr. Curtis?
Thank you, Madam Chairperson. I remind committee members that in conformity with Rule 4 of the committee's rules of procedures, the committee shall examine at each session, in consultation with the Director General, the date and place of its next session. The Bureau may, if necessary, modify the date and or place in consultation with the Director General. So concerning the venue, I would like to inform the committee that has just been mentioned by the chairperson, the Secretariat has not received any invitations from interested committee members to host the committee's session next year. We therefore propose to hold the session in UNESCO headquarters in Paris. And concerning the date, we have some considerations to take into account, particularly, firstly, the coordination with the other conventions of the culture sector. As many of you are aware, there's multiple meetings and we must make sure they don't overlap. And of course, we need to take into account that next year is a general conference here in UNESCO, and there are the possible dates for the 41st session of the general conference, which are not yet confirmed. And then finally, of course, the approval of the Director General. So we are proposing at this stage the dates of 13th to 18th of December. It is a little bit late in the calendar, but that is necessary because there is a general conference to be held here at UNESCO next year. Thank you, Madam Chairperson.
Thank you, Mr. Curtis. This seems to be very clear, members. Can we agree on this? I see no objection, so I thank you for agreeing. I propose that we amend our decision to reflect the fact that no committee member has proposed to host the 16th session. May I ask the committee to adopt draft decision 15.11 as amended by the Secretariat and ask that it be put up on the screen. So the draft decision is up on the screen. I see no objections. Not a minute or two. No objection. I therefore declare 15.11 adopted. Colleagues, now that we have discussed the date and venue of the 16th session of the committee in 2021, we have to elect the next bureau of the committee. Please refer to document 12. Mr. Curtis, please take the floor to explain this item to us. Thank you.
Thank you, Madam Chairperson. Please allow me to recall that in accordance with Rules 12 and 13 of the Rules of Procedure, the committee shall elect its bureau, which consists of a chairperson, one or more vice chairpersons, and a rapporteur, who shall remain in office until the end of the next ordinary session. When electing the bureau, the committee shall have due regard to the need to ensure equitable geographical representation and, in as much as possible, a balance among the various fields of intangible cultural heritage, in accordance with Rule 13.4. Of course, the members of the Bureau also need to be members of the committee. It has been the custom of this committee in the last few years that all electoral groups be represented in its bureau through the chairperson and vice chairpersons. In such cases, according to the Office of International Standards and Legal Affairs, the rapporteur should not express his or her opinion or vote in the capacity as rapporteur. This is to respect the principle of equitable geographical representation within the bureau, pursuant to Rule 12.1 of the Rules of Procedure. His or her role is to validate the decisions that the committee and its bureau take after they have been prepared by the Secretariat. Thank you, Madam Chairperson.
Thank you, Mr. Curtis. Colleagues, we find ourselves presented with an unusual situation this year. As you all know, it is customary that the chairperson of the committee shall be from the host country. However, with the session now scheduled to take place at UNESCO headquarters next year, the normal arrangement cannot apply. Yet, we still need to identify a chairperson, as was discussed in the Bureau today. Because of the unprecedented times we find ourselves in, the necessary consultations to identify a chairperson could not be undertaken. In order to resolve this situation, the following procedure was discussed in the Bureau. We will proceed to elect 6 Bureau members, one from each electoral group. We would then ask the indulgence of the committee to suspend part of Rule 13.1 by 2/3 majority of the committee members present and voting to give the Bureau time to identify a chairperson. In January, a nominal chairperson will be elected from amongst the existing vice chairpersons through electronic consultation with Bureau members. This solution will also leave open the possibility, should the situation change, to allow one of the vice chairpersons to come forward as a host. You may remember that we were faced with a similar situation at the 12th session of the committee with decision 12.20, when we had already decided that the 13th session would take place in Mauritius, but the nominal chairperson had not been immediately identified. In this case, we also decided to elect the chairperson through electronic consultation with the committee. If the proposed solution is agreeable, I will ask the Secretariat to propose an alternative draft decision which will allow us to elect the chairperson of the committee for its 16th session from amongst the vice chairpersons through electronic consultation by 15 March 2021 at the latest. Do you have any objections as to suspend a part of the Rule 13.1 of our rules of procedure to give the Bureau time to identify a chairperson? Members, may I ask if anyone wishes at this time to take the floor? Well, I see that we have an agreement to the solution I propose. So let us proceed accordingly. May I invite the members of the committee to make a proposal concerning the rapporteur?
Okay.
Mr. Curtis?
Madam Chair, I propose we first go then to the next part. Perhaps the rapporteur may also have to be chosen later as for the chair. Or we will try, if any individual in the committee wishes to come forward as rapporteur, or wishes to volunteer, it would be most helpful. But otherwise, you may want to go to the next, to go to the electoral groups, and we can see if somebody wishes to be rapporteur. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Curtis. I understand through the Bureau that we have proposals for the vice chairpersons, electoral group one. So group one, could you please give us your proposal? Thank you.
Thank you, Madam Chair. That is correct. We propose Sweden to be vice chair. Thank you.
Electoral group two, your proposal.
Merci, Madame la Présidente. Nous proposons la République Tchèque.
Group three, your proposal, please.
Thank you, Madam Chair. We're very pleased to propose Brazil, representing Group 3. Thank you.
Thank you. Group 4, your proposal, please.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Group 4 would like to propose Sri Lanka, representing our group for the next bureau. Thank you.
Thank you. Group 5A, your proposal, please.
Le groupe 5A, merci Madame la Présidente, sera représenté par Djibouti.
Thank you. Group 5B, your proposal, please.
Thank you, Madame Chair. We are honored to have the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia representing Group 5 at the Bureau.
Thank you. Do we have any information at this time, or a proposal, or for a rapporteur?
Madam Chair, I think we might need just a little time to consult. 1 minute. This stage, we appeal to committee members. If there's any individual who would be willing to step forward as a rapporteur. Otherwise, I think, Madam Chair, we'll have to go for now without a rapporteur, and we'll have to fix that at a later stage. But it will require an electronic consultation. So I would appeal to any committee member who is willing to take on the role of rapporteur. Perhaps our current rapporteur could remind that it is not too demanding. It is merely validating the work we do.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Yes, Madam Chair. I'm really willing to do that. It's not that of a much of a burden. Actually, it's quite nice to have an overview every day of the decisions that have been taken. So it helped me a lot to get an overview of where we are with the work. So not a burden at all. Thank you.
Thank you, Netherlands, for volunteering. Thank you so much. At this time, I propose that we amend our decision to reflect our discussion. Can we adopt the whole decision as proposed by the Secretary?
Madam Chair? Unfortunately, if we adopt without the rapporteur, we'll have to go through another procedure for a suspension of the rules of procedures. Could we ask for a few minutes to see? And we really appeal to somebody from the committee to be willing to be rapporteur for next year. And otherwise, we have to see how we will proceed if we do not have a rapporteur, how we can legally proceed.
May I suggest we have a reggae chill moment?
Thank you, Madam Chair.
Thank you.
So
Madam Chair, are you there?
Yes, Mr. Curtis.
I believe we have a proposal and a name, perhaps I believe from the delegation of Japan.
Very good. Excellent. So we should applaud Japan and thank Japan at this point. Congratulations. Thank you. Applause, applause, applause. The reggae chill moment worked. So at this point, I propose that we amend our decision to reflect our discussion. Can we adopt the whole decision as proposed by the Secretariat, which I am asking to be put up on the screen?
Madam Chair, we're just putting in the names of the countries that were read out now. Thank you.
Thank you.
And of the name of the rapporteur in a nominal capacity, which is Ms. Jun Takai from Japan. Thank you.
Thank you. Colleagues, can we adopt the whole decision as proposed, which is now shown on the screen? I see no objections, and so I therefore declare decision 15.12 adopted as amended. Colleagues, at this time I would like to propose that we now move on to the examination item 13 on the other business. Do you have any issues you wish to discuss under this item, colleagues? Chekia, you may have the floor.
Merci, Madame la Présidente. Tout d'abord, permettez-moi de féliciter sincèrement tous les États membres. Particulièrement ceux.
On vous entend pas. Pouvez-vous vérifier votre microphone, s'il vous plaît?
Entendez-vous?
Maintenant, on vous entend.
D'accord. Merci beaucoup. Je voudrais féliciter les États parties qui ont préparé et inscrit leurs éléments dans cette session et surtout ceux qui les ont soumis, qui ont soumis les premiers dossiers de candidature. Une session de comité s'achève et la suivante commencera doucement à prendre forme. À la lumière des discussions autour des différents points à l'ordre du jour et en particulier des dossiers de candidature, nous constatons une certaine disparité dans les attentes et les approches des membres du comité. Dans ce contexte, nous aimerions inviter nos distingués collègues à réfléchir à la question suivante. D'installer un système de consultation informelle avec tous les membres du comité intéressés. Notre délégation considère qu'en tant que membres du comité, nous pourrions nous consulter et préparer dans la mesure du possible des positions communes mieux harmonisées, et cela pas seulement pendant la session du comité, mais aussi avant le début de nos travaux, par exemple après que les documents de travail pour la prochaine session sont publiés. Chers collègues, nous sommes des gardiens de la Convention et une de nos tâches est de veiller à sa bonne mise en œuvre. Les inscriptions de nouveaux éléments font toujours plaisir dans la large famille des communautés représentant diverses traditions vivantes, mais nous ne devrions pas oublier dans cette joie partagée que certains dossiers présentent divers problèmes et lacunes qui ont impact sur leur sauvegarde et qui ne disparaissent pas quand les recommandations de l'organe d'évaluation changent. On doit s'assurer que les États soumissionnaires, ensemble avec les communautés concernées, puissent relever ces défis identifiés par l'organe d'évaluation et d'y répondre dans le respect de la Convention. Se consulter plus, communiquer plus nos intentions et trouver des solutions consensuelles devrait nous bénéficier à tous, à nos communautés, à nos éléments et au PCI en général. Madame la Présidente, merci pour la façon dont vous avez mené nos travaux. Merci à tous les collègues du comité, à l'organe d'évaluation, au secrétariat. Vive la Convention, vive le PCI et joyeuses fêtes à vous tous. Merci.
Thank you, Chekia. Thank you so much. Thank you. I thank you, Chekia, for your suggestions, and we will reflect on them in the summary records. Any other comments? I see none, and so we can now move on to item 14, adoption of the list of decisions. Colleagues, according to the practice, committee members adopt the list of all decisions adopted up to the lunch break of the last day when we meet for committee meetings in presentia. The committee delegates to its rapporteur the responsibility to validate the rest of the decisions. Given the online modality and reduced time of this session, our timetable this year does not foresee breaks. For this reason, and in the interest of time, I therefore propose that we delegate to the rapporteur the responsibility to validate all the decisions instead. This will save us a lot of time. I hope that you have no objections with the approach. I see none. I would like to thank the rapporteur, I would like to thank the rapporteur from Netherlands for making sure that the decisions taken during the committee properly reflects our discussions. Thank you all. Ladies and gentlemen, colleagues all, we have now come to the end of an intense and very, very productive week. I wish to congratulate you all for what has been no small feat. In fact, you have done what no other session of the Intergovernmental Committee has accomplished before. You have managed to debate and decide on all of the items in our agenda in a fully online modality, with only half of our normal daily working hours. Thanks to your enthusiasm, your cooperation, and your willingness to work together in the spirit of consensus, we have accomplished a tremendous number of tasks. Your flexibility to work in a new way and your commitment to make this a successful session despite many challenges have made my work as chairperson thoroughly rewarding and enjoyable. My special thanks goes to my fellow bureau members, dear vice chairpersons and rapporteur. You made my job as chairperson much easier, and you greatly helped to facilitate our debates. To all of the committee members, delegates, and representatives who have joined us online these past 6 days, I offer you my sincere thanks. Before we close, allow me to summarize the achievements of our work during the committee meeting. During the session, at times we had 1,100 people following simultaneously online. And of these, there were 833 registered participants from 141 different countries. We have examined 44 files as part of the 2020 cycle. Of these files, 3 have been inscribed in the urgent safeguarding list, and 29 on the representative list. In addition, we have included 3 programs on the register of good safeguarding practices. We examined 9 reports on the current status of elements inscribed on the urgent safeguarding list from Brazil, Indonesia, Iran, Islamic Republic of Iran, Mali, Mongolia, Uganda, and the United Arab Emirates. We have also taken important decisions related to the number of files to be reached or to be treated in the 2022 and 2023 cycles. And finally, we have established a new evaluation body for the 2021 cycle, including three new members. These are just a few of our many achievements this week. Colleagues, ladies and gentlemen, as you will have no doubt have noticed, this session of the committee required a podium in Paris, another in Kingston, and yet another for the evaluation body. We owe our thanks to the teams on all sides. In this regard, I express our greatest appreciation to the interpreters, translators, technicians, and everyone else working behind the scenes who have kept this session of the committee running smoothly online. Let us give them all a big round of applause. Finally, I offer my most sincere gratitude to the Director General, Assistant Director General for Culture, and the Secretary of the Convention and his team for all their preparation and hard work before and during the session, especially for the extra effort required this year to adapt the meeting to the new online modality. Distinguished delegates, although you could not all be with us here in Jamaica, as we had sincerely wanted, I hope that our reggae chill moments brought the colors and sounds of our vibrant country into your homes and offices. Our music comes from our heart to yours with a redemption song, songs of freedom and solidarity for a wonderful world and our beautiful people. We work to attain one love. Before proceeding with the closure of this session, I would like to give a final opportunity to anyone wishing to make closing statements. However, prior to that, please join me for just one more reggae experience we organized especially for you. This features the son of reggae icon Bob Marley, Julian Marley, doing your favorite song, One Love. Please enjoy.
Ooh. One, one, one. One, 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 one. Hey. One love. One heart. Together and feel all right.
Hey, let's
get together and feel all right. Whoa, let them men pass all their dirty remarks. There is one question I really love to ask. Is there a place for the hopeless sinners who have
together and feel all right.
Ooh, let's get together and feel all right.
Let's get together. Got to unite right now. Got to live in love right now. Let's get together and feel alright. Unite, yeah. East, west, north and south. No matter where you are. Gotta get together now.
I hope that you have enjoyed the performance of Julia and Marley. Now, I have requests from the floor, statements from state parties, and I see Jamaica at the top of the list. Jamaica, the floor is yours.
Madam Chairperson, the Assistant Director General, and all staff of UNESCO, the cultural, intangible cultural heritage team, excellencies and representative of members of the committee, states party, observers, NGOs. Madam Chair, the Jamaican delegation is so pleased to see you and to acknowledge your sterling leadership of this meeting of the committee, having led us safely and efficiently to harbor in record time. The steadiness of your gavel and the calm of the reggae chill moments will live in our memories. This staging of the committee's meeting has been significant. We were able to add to the growing list of inscriptions some 32 important elements, thereby contributing to the body of intangible cultural heritage globally, which will be preserved and protected. The committee has also proven itself to be able to pivot and respond to the challenges posed by the pandemic, by being able to carry out its work in unique, creative, and effective ways. These two developments are intrinsically linked and offer us a roadmap for the studied flexibility with which the committee must continue to approach its work, even as we do so on the basis of principles and procedures which have been established. We also congratulate those who have been elected to the evaluation body, and those states parties who have been successful with their inscriptions. Jamaica is grateful for the role played by all the members of the committee in the work of this 15.com. We commend heartily the Secretariat, which has worked closely and tirelessly with the delegation to ensure the smooth conduct of this meeting. Let me extend best wishes to all of you for continued good health and safety, and for a peaceful and enjoyable season and every blessing into the new year. I thank you, Madam Chairperson.
Thank you, Jamaica. Poland, you may take the floor.
Thank you, Madam Chairperson. Poland wishes to congratulate you, Madam Chairperson, for your leadership during this unique and historical 15th session of Intangible Cultural Heritage Committee. We would like to also thank your team behind you, which with great dedication work for this session to run. This session has been different and historical for many reasons. We all proved ourselves that despite difficult conditions caused by the COVID-19 pandemic, we managed to continue our duties as committee members to ensure the continuity of functioning of the mechanism of the 2003 convention. We have now several new elements on the representative list, the list of urgent safeguarding, and new inscriptions on the good practice registry. For the first time, a new item was presented, the report of the ICH NGO Forum. Poland wishes to underline that we appreciate the important work that the ICH NGO Forum is contributing to the implementation of 2003 Convention and we welcomed with satisfaction its readiness to assure an enhanced advisory role to the committee. However, because of the health crisis, we were not able to continue working on the global reform of the listing mechanism. We hope that the next year, knowing all the new modalities for living in times of pandemic, we will be able to continue this process, which will help us strengthen the mechanism under 2003 Convention in the future. Many thanks we wish to address to the Secretariat for providing us with the working environment which enabled us to fulfill our obligations as committee members. Last but not least, we wish to thank all the committee members for your great cooperation in the sense of dialogue and mutual respect. The global health crisis taught us that no matter the circumstances, we are able to find solutions to continue our work. We are looking forward to cooperate with you in the next session, hopefully in presencia. As Bob Marley just sang, let's get together and feel all right. I wish you all, let's stay together and be all right. Thank you, Madam Chair.
Thank you, Paula, and thank you so much. Panama, you may take the floor.
Gracias, señora presidenta. Agradecemos a usted por su excelente conducción de la 15ª sesión de nuestro comité, así como a los miembros del comité, a la secretaría, los observadores y los organizadores en general. Aprovecho para agradecer también al subdirector de Cultura, Ernesto Otonde, que nos pudo acompañar en el día de hoy. Hemos realizado importantes discusiones sobre los mecanismos de trabajo futuros, cooperando hacia el cumplimiento de los objetivos de la Convención que Panamá respalda plenamente. Les extendemos un saludo del señor ministro de Cultura, Carlos Aguilar, y agradecemos la participación y nos veremos en el futuro, ojalá una vez concluido este periodo tan difícil de la pandemia que azota al mundo entero, nuevamente podamos reunirnos todos. Gracias.
Thank you, Panama. Botswana, you may take the floor. Thank you.
Thank you, Madam Chair and Honorable Minister. We take the floor to congratulate you for the manner with which you conducted and managed this unique and historic 15th session of the ICH. We would have loved to have been with you in Jamaica and enjoy the splendor and beauty of your beautiful and wonderful country. But unfortunately, COVID-19 prevented us from going. However, we were grateful that you gave us a taste of what you have to offer the world in the music that we listened to and tapped our feet and rocked our heads every day of this session. There were certainly reggae-chill moments indeed. Together with the excellent backstopping provided by Dr. Curtis and his team, you managed to pull off this meeting successfully despite all the odds. We thank the Secretariat for the professional manner with which they facilitated the 15th session and the manner with which all the files were handled. We also appreciate the good work of the evaluation body, without whom we would be lost. Last but not least, we thank our fellow committee members for their contribution to making this meeting a success. One advantage of the online meeting was that it enabled small countries like my own to have a greater number of people participating from my country. Perhaps that is a silver lining for future meetings, but I think we all prefer meetings in presentia. Thank you once again, Chairperson. One love.
Thank you. One love to you from Jamaica.
Thank you.
Botswana. I now recognize Kuwait.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Thank you, ADG. Thank you, Tim and your team. And thank you, Biro. Thank you, the evaluation body. Thank you, the committee members. Also, thank you, the Kuwait expert in Kuwait. And finally, thank you, Jamaica.
Thank you, too. Thank you. Netherlands, you may take the floor.
Thank you, Madam Chair. We would like to congratulate you, Madam, for your excellent leadership and for the many reggae chill moments. They really helped. We wish to thank the Secretariat for the hard work, and the excellent documents in these extraordinary times. And we congratulate the new members of the evaluation body. And we look forward to better times in which we can meet in person and have our discussions in person, and to times in which communities can practice their ICH and the richness of ICH can shine in the world. We look forward to continue to cooperate in a constructive and positive way. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Netherlands. Sri Lanka, you may take the floor. Thank you.
Thank you, Madam Chair, for giving me this opportunity. This is an extraordinary session given the circumstances created by the pandemic. So we congratulate once again you, the Chair, for your excellent leadership and also the Secretariat and his staff. We also congratulate the new evaluation body. And all the state parties who were successfully submitted the nomination files. Thank you again for electing Sri Lanka to the Bureau. We all together were able to defeat the threat of the pandemic and successfully conduct our meeting. So thank you all those who contributed to this success. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Sri Lanka. Japan, you may take the floor.
Merci, Madame la Présidente. We would like to thank you, the ADG, the Secretariat, and the evaluation body and everybody, the committee members, to have this successful meeting, although the situation was not in the perfect way. Although we miss not being able to go to Jamaica, we enjoyed all the chill music that was played every day. We are really looking forward for the discussion, which is going to be on for the reflection process, which is going to kickstart in February. And we are going to stay committed to this important, valuable organization and the intangible culture. Thank you again to everybody. Thanks.
Thank you, Japan. I now recognize China.
Thank you, Madam Chair. My delegation would like to express our sincere appreciation for your highly efficient chairmanship to guide this committee throughout the tight schedule. Our thanks also go to the evaluation body, the secretariat, and all the committee members. This year, we had a special committee session in a full online modality. We may not have had enough in-depth discussions due to the global time differences. We still succeeded in completing our duties and tasks in the spirit of cooperation and reached a productive consensus. Madam Chair, dear colleagues, the pandemic, among other challenges and risks, is posing great threat to people's life and the social development, as well as the practices and transmission of the intangible cultural heritage. China reiterates its commitment to the safeguarding of the ICH and would like to join our hands with all the committee members to contribute
to the sustainable development and implementation of the 2003 Convention. Madam Chair, once again, thank you, and thank you for the live reggae music every day, and best wishes to you all. Thank you very much.
Thank you, China. Côte d'Ivoire, you may take the floor.
Merci, Madame la Présidente. Je souhaiterais tout d'abord vous féliciter pour votre leadership. Vous avez travaillé de manière extraordinaire. Je voudrais également, Madame la Présidente, avec votre permission, féliciter le secrétariat, car ils nous ont montré qu'ils pouvaient faire face à toutes les difficultés. Je voudrais également remercier l'organe d'évaluation, féliciter les pays qui ont pu inscrire un bien et féliciter une dernière fois l'UNESCO pour cette prouesse. Je vous remercie.
Thank you, Côte d'Ivoire. Morocco, the floor is yours.
Merci, Madame la Présidente. Je voudrais, à la fin de nos travaux, vous féliciter très chaleureusement pour la manière excellente dont vous avez dirigé nos travaux. Je souhaiterais également remercier M. Curtis et toute l'équipe de la Convention 2003, ainsi que tous les membres du comité. Je pense que ça a été une réunion réussie, malgré les conditions exceptionnelles que nous vivons actuellement. Je souhaite me retrouver dans des conditions meilleures. Merci beaucoup, Madame la Présidente.
Thank you. Switzerland, you may take the floor. Thank you. Switzerland, the floor is yours.
Madame la Présidente, merci. J'aimerais, à l'instar des collègues qui m'ont précédé, vous, au nom de la Suisse et de sa délégation, vous féliciter et vous remercier pour la manière avec laquelle vous avez conduit avec sagesse et tact et efficacité nos travaux et bien sûr remercier la Jamaïque pour son hospitalité. J'aimerais remercier également les membres du secrétariat et le secrétaire de la Convention, ainsi que les membres de l'organe d'évaluation pour cette réunion très réussie, malgré les difficultés que nous connaissons tous. J'aimerais aussi étendre ces remerciements à nos collègues membres du comité. Nous avons réussi à compenser et à surpasser les obstacles, les difficultés, le manque de discussion et la distance entre nous, par un esprit extrêmement constructif et positif qui augure bien pour la suite de nos travaux. Avant de conclure, j'aimerais réitérer l'engagement de la Suisse en faveur du patrimoine immatériel et de notre coopération internationale autour de cet élément. Et je vous remercie, Madame la Présidente.
Thank you, Switzerland. Azerbaijan, please take the floor.
Thank you, Madam Chair, for your excellent management and leadership of the committee session. And I would like to thank also the Secretariat for the excellent organization, management, and communication that they organized the committee session. And I do wish that this is our first online committee meeting and it will be our last committee meeting online. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Brazil, the floor is yours.
Gracias. Gracias, señora presidenta. Palabras solamente de agradecimiento, en primer lugar a usted, por la forma extraordinaria con que condujo estos trabajos y nos permitió avanzar en una agenda que ha permitido la entrada de nuevos elementos en las diferentes listas del patrimonio inmaterial. Gracias por habernos permitido, de una forma virtual, debemos reconocerlo, aprovechar un poco de su hermoso país con este reggae que hemos escuchado durante todos estos momentos. A mí personalmente me hubiese gustado volver a su país, que tanto me encanta, pero el reggae ya me ayudó, he de decirlo. Muchísimas gracias. Quiero agradecer al secretariado por la forma como condujo y como ayudó y todos los documentos que hemos recibido, al comité evaluador y a todos aquellos que han hecho posible esta reunión virtual, que ha sido, a nuestro ver, un excelente suceso y éxito. Queremos también felicitar a todos los países y a las comunidades cuyos elementos han sido incorporados en las listas. Quiero hacer una particular referencia a aquellos de América Latina y de Iberoamérica, que son los que están más próximos históricamente de nuestro corazón. Y muchísimas gracias nuevamente por todo este momento, y queremos agradecer la elección de Brasil para el COVID, para el virus. Muchísimas gracias, señora presidenta.
Thank you, Brazil. Saudi Arabia, the floor is yours.
Thank you, Your Excellency. We'd like to voice our appreciation to Jamaica for hosting this 15th session of the committee in such a dire circumstances. We'd also like to congratulate all state parties for their items inscribed in this year's session. Saudi Arabia deeply believes in the role of culture in building bridges between countries and cultures and societies. We thank Kuwait and Morocco for entrusting us to represent the Group 5B. We'd also like to express our commitment to withhold and protect the values and principles of this convention, and to support the Secretariat and all its member states to carry out their mandates in an effective and efficient manner. And most of all, thank you for the beautiful raga music that we all enjoyed, and thank you for your beautiful leadership, Madam Chair. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Saudi Arabia. I understand that the state's parties and non-committee members are wishing to speak, and I would love to hear their presentations. However, I want to thank them for their interest and to indicate that because I have to manage our time, and we are now running out of time, I would like to invite only committee members at this time to take the floor. But I do appreciate the fact that non-committee members would wish to also make their comments. We thank you. So the fact that we are running out of time, may I ask if Assistant Director General for Culture wishes to say the final words.
Thank you so much, Madam Chairperson. It's always, as I said before, a pleasure to see you. We would rather have had this committee in Kingston, but nevertheless, it was a great reggae chill moment for all of us to ending this year with this beautiful music. I must say that this has certainly not been a straightforward session of the committee to organize. We met many difficulties, as no doubt many of you did in your work this year. However, I think you will agree with me that through hard work and perseverance, we have all managed to overcome these challenges to yet again hold a successful session of the Intergovernmental Committee. The 15th session will be one that we all gonna remember. This year has been a surefire proof of our ability to adapt to ever-changing needs and of the unquestionable importance of the 2003 Convention. My sincerest thanks must go to the Jamaicans for their incredible hospitality, which we could feel even through this online modality, and in particular to our chairperson, Minister Grange. Also, we all deeply regret not being there with you in Jamaica to dance. You have truly accomplished something remarkable by successfully leading us through this online session of the committee. You and your team should be proud. I, of course, also owe a tremendous thanks to all of the delegates for all of their support during this year and the committee members, in particular for the spirit of cooperation demonstrated during the present meeting. It is through this strong working relationship that we are able to accomplish so much together. In this regard, I would like to extend my welcome to the delegates who are new committee members. You have had a very particular introduction to the work of the committee, and I look forward to working with all of you for our next meeting. And those of you who may be present with us for the last time, we thank you for your commitment to the work of the convention. If I may, Madame, I would like to make special mention for Ms. Riet de Leuf from the Netherlands, who will be retiring this year and who has been closely involved with this convention since the beginning and has done so much for the safeguarding of intangible cultural heritage. I am sure others join me in thanking you for your tireless efforts and in wishing you the best for the next chapter in your life. Dear colleague, as the year 2020 comes to a close, I wish also to thank the three members of the evaluation body who left us during this period. Madame Sonia Montesino of Chile, Ms. Hien Thieu Nguyen of Vietnam, and the NGO Société Égyptienne pour la Tradition Folklorique. I thank you all for your continued support for the work of the Secretariat. After this successful meeting together, we have much reflection to undertake, and we fully intend to take on 2021 with a renewed sense of energy and rigor, and of course, with the reggae behind you. Thank you very much to everyone. And thank you to the staff of the Secretariat who is doing a remarkable work. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ADG. It has been truly a pleasure for me and my team to work with you and your team. We'd send Jamaica big up. Big up to Tim. Big up to the team in the Secretariat. And so all that's left for me to do is to say that it's really, really been a wonderful experience for us. You will see my team gathered here behind me, and we all want to applaud you for your work. And after I have declared the 15th session closed, you can enjoy some reggae chill moments as we go out with a great vibe. And so, all that's left for me to do at this time is to say, I hereby declare the 15th session of the Intergovernmental Committee for the Safeguarding of the Intangible Cultural Heritage closed.
I'm a capture. see the morning sun. Travel wide. I'm a rebel. Oh yeah, now rebel in the morning time.
So rebel.
And in the evening too.
I'm a capturer. Soul adventurer.
Say I believe. Blue.